Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you 200 best multiple choice questions from the month of March 2018. This video will be brought to you in English language by me. My name is Gaurav. Now remember that the number of questions in this video has far exceeded 200. In fact, they are 300. And the reason is, if you recall in my last video, I did not cover the 4th week of February because I uploaded the video a little bit early. And I uploaded it around 23rd of February, and therefore I was not able to include the last week of February. So in this video, around 25 to 30 questions I have included from February 4th week, and I have included 50 to 60 extra questions from March 2018 than usual, because I consider the quality of these questions as very good and I did not want to take a chance. So I have done extra hard work, and I'm sure if I can do that hard work, I'm sure so can you. So starting this video, StudyIQ's pen drive courses are available for SSC, Bank PO, Railways, Junior Engineer Exam, UPSC, GS and optional State PCS and Defense Exam, also for Law Exam and KVS. If you want to buy any of our course, then go to studyiq.com. You can now connect with me on Instagram. Now remember, I will start conducting quiz on Instagram tomorrow onwards. So if you want to participate, then follow me on Tireless Soul. This is my ID. Even if you search by Dr. Gaurav Garg, you can still find me. Same on Twitter, my ID is GauravGarg888. So first of all, let me bring to you around 20 to 25 questions from the February 4th week. First question is, how much amount of loan has Asian Development Bank given to Bihar for their water supply project? They have financed the water supply project in Bihar. The loan is $84 million. Overall, they will give $200 million, but they have given 84 for now, and we'll see the leftover. Now, Bihar, JDU is the ruling party in coalition with BJP, Janata Dal United, and Nitish Kumar is the CM. He became the CM for sixth time. Bihar's capital is Patna, and Bihar has a very famous wildlife sanctuary called Bhimbandh Wildlife Sanctuary, which is in Munger district in Bihar, and it also has Valmiki National Park, which is the only national park of Bihar. So also remember, Asian Development Bank, the highest share in this bank is of Japan, followed by America, followed by China, and then India. So India is fourth highest shareholder in this bank. This bank is headquartered in Manila, which is the capital of Philippines. And the president of this bank is Takehiko Nakao from Japan. Mr. Takehiko Nakao from Japan. Who launched the subsidized Amma two-wheeler scheme for working women in Tamil Nadu? Amma was the name of Jayalalitha, the former chief minister of Tamil Nadu, who had an unfortunate demise. And Jayalalitha, it was on her 70th birth anniversary that the government of Tamil Nadu launched Amma two-wheeler scheme, where 25,000 rupees or 50% off, 50% subsidy will be given to a woman who wants to buy a two-wheeler. This scheme was inaugurated by Mr. Narendra Modi. You can see Narendra Modi. Tamil Nadu, there is a dance called Bharatanatyam, and there is Mukurthi National Park, Mukurthi, and there is Gwindi National Park, Tamil Nadu. Capital is Chennai, and CM is Edappadi K. Palaniswami. The party name is AIADMK, All Indiana Dravid Munnetra Kazhagam. So that's all you need to know about this. Which country has been elected as the Vice President of the Financial Action Task Force? Remember that the meeting of FATF took place in Paris. Paris will host the 2024 Olympic Games. It is the capital of France. It is the headquarters of UNESCO and or OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. And Pakistan was put in the grey list because it was unable to stop terrorism. So it was put in the grey list. Vice presidency has been given to China. Which railway station has become the second railway station in India to be managed only by women? The management, the entire management consists of only women. It is Gandhinagar Railway Station. It is in Jaipur. This is not the Gandhinagar capital of Gujarat. This is not that Gandhinagar. This is a mini railway station in Jaipur, Gandhinagar Railway Station. First was Matunga. And Matunga is in Mumbai. And now, of course, after the first two, there are a series of railway stations which are managed by women. In fact, on the occasion of International Women's Day, which we celebrated on 8th of March, there were 200 railway stations that were announced by the Ministry of Railways that will be managed only by women. Which Union Territory will host the biannual multinational naval event called Milan 2018 with the underlying theme Friendship Across the Seas? It will be hosted by Andaman Nicobar, Capital of Andaman Nicobar is Port Blair. It also has cellular jail. And the airport in Port Blair is called Veer Savarkar International Airport. Andaman Nicobar also has Barren Island, which is the only active volcano of India. And another volcano is there, which is called Narcon Dam. Port Blair is in South Andaman. And Andaman Nicobar is located in the Bay of Bengal. So remember all these facts about Andaman Nicobar. And there are two important tribes in Andaman. One is called Onga, and the second one is called Jarawa. Onga and Jarawa. Who has become the first Indian to win an individual medal at the Gymnastics World Cup? What is her name? She won a bronze medal. You can see here. Her name is Aruna Buddhareddy. And this Gymnastics World Cup took place in Melbourne. Melbourne is in Australia, and there is a famous cricket ground called Melbourne Cricket Ground where the first ever cricket match took place between Australia and England. Reserve Bank of India recently launched Ombudsman scheme for non-banking financial companies. The Ombudsman offices will function in how many cities? So let me give you some prelude to this question. Ombudsman scheme is for, there are 20 Ombudsman office in India. Okay, 20. But this is only for banks. Why do we need an Ombudsman? Because he listens to the complaints of the people free of cost. So for example, if you have any complaint with the bank, you write to the bank. Okay, you write a letter to the bank. If the bank does not give you a reply within 30 days, or if the bank gives you a reply within 30 days but you are not satisfied, or if the bank does not acknowledge your complaint, in these three circumstances, you can approach the Ombudsman for grievances redressal, and then swift action is taken with free of cost. Now the Ombudsman scheme is started for non-banking financial companies, but not all. Only those non-banking financial companies which have assets of more than 100 crore, or the non-banking financial companies which can accept deposits, only for these. And later on it will be applied to other non-banking financial companies also. Total 4 offices have been opened, where one in Delhi, Chennai, then Mumbai and Kolkata. 4 metros: Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai and Chennai. These are the 4 offices which have been opened for non-banking financial companies. Which country has topped the medal tally in the Pyeongchang 2018 Olympic Winter Games, which concluded recently in South Korea? Pyeongchang is in South Korea and Pyongyang is the capital of North Korea. Don't confuse the two. Pyongyang and Pyeongchang are different, okay? Pyeongchang is in South Korea. I am sure had North Korea hosted, nobody would have participated. Anyways, so pay attention to this question. It is saying Olympic Winter Games. It is not saying Olympic Paralympic Winter Game. There is a difference. If they ask Paralympics, then USA won the maximum medals. If they ask only Olympic, then the answer is Norway. Norway won 39 medals, which is a record in itself. No country has won 39 medals before Norway. Norway's capital is Oslo. And Norway, there is a very famous player. He is a chess champion of the world. His name is Magnus Carlsen. He is from Norway. And he won the World Blitz Championship. And he is also the world champion. So he is world blitz champion. However, world rapid champion is Vishwanathan Anand from Tamil Nadu. Remember that. And also the mascot were different. So one of the mascot, I think I have written, yeah. So the mascot for the Winter Olympics was Sohorang. It is a white tiger. And for Paralympics, it was Bandabi, which is an Asiatic black bear. The slogan of the games was Passion Connected. And Norway, not only finished first, but they also broke the record of America with 39 medals. And there is a player from Norway called Marit Bjørgen. Okay, Marit Bjørgen, he won 15 medals. The one player won 15 medals. Okay, so he made history. Which of the following has become the first associate member of ICC, International Cricket Council, to get approval from a global T20 venture? Which basically means, so for example, in India, we have IPL, right? It is a T20 franchise. Similarly, Canada has got the permission. Now it can start its own Canada Premier League for cricket. Which company's payment bank has recently began operations? The first payment bank to open in India was Bharti Airtel Payment Bank. Second payment bank to open in India was the India Post Payment Bank. And India Post Payment Bank is the only government sector payment bank in India. Rest all are private. Third one was the Paytm Payment Bank, and fourth was the Fino Payment Bank. Recently opened one is Aditya Birla Payment Bank. And remember, Idea is merging with Vodafone. Idea is a company from the Aditya Birla Group. It is a telecom company. Asian Development Bank has announced to provide an assistance of $1 million because there was a cyclone called Gita. Now, where did Gita stuck? It stuck in Tonga. Tonga is the name of a country and the capital of Tonga is Nuku'alofa. Also remember, in Australia, recently a cyclone came. Its name was Kelvin. K-E-L-V-I-N. Kelvin is also the SI unit of measuring temperature. Okay. And so therefore, Asian Development Bank is giving a loan, is a financial assistance, not a loan. It is a financial assistance. It's a grant of $1 million. Which Indian player has won the men's singles at the Austrian Open International Challenge? Men's singles. His name is Parupalli Kashyap. Parupalli Kashyap, he won it. This was the Austrian Open International Challenge. And remember, Austria's capital is Vienna. And Vienna, for 9th year in a row, has been declared the best city to live in, you know, by Mercer Quality Index. For ninth year in a row. And Vienna is also the headquarters of OPEC, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. Which state government has constituted a state council? They want to promote Urdu language. Also remember, Telangana, the latest state, the 29th state of India, Telangana recently declared Urdu as their second official language after Telugu. Telugu is spoken in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. It is their main language. But Urdu in Telangana is now the second official language. But the state that we are talking about here is Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir has Kishtwar National Park. How to remember? See, in Jammu Kashmir, there is always a war going on. No. Kishtwar National Park. There is also Dr. Salim Ali National Park. Remember that Dr. Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary is in Goa and Dr. Salim Ali National Park is in Jammu Kashmir. Don't confuse the two. And we also have Hemis National Park, which is the largest national park of India. And one more is important, which is called Dachigam National Park. There is a Kishan Ganga River project also in Jammu Kashmir. And there is a dance also called Rauf, R-A-U-F-F. It is the name of a tribe also. And N.N. Vohra is the governor. Mehbooba Mufti of the People's Democratic Party is the CM. Capital is Srinagar. There is a Jhelum River also here. There is Wooler Lake. There is Dal Lake. That's enough for you, I guess. Kunwar Bai, she passed away recently. She was the mascot or ambassador of which government scheme? She was 106 years old. She was from Chhattisgarh. And why she was important is because she sold all her goats. And the money that she got from selling her goats, she built a toilet. So this was a very good gesture. And she was appreciated by both Pradhan Mantri Modi and CM of Chhattisgarh, Dr. Raman Singh. She was the mascot of Clean India campaign, that is Swachh Bharat. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he has announced to establish a defense industrial corridor at a cost of 20,000 crore rupees. Please remember, this is the second industrial defense corridor in India. It will be built in Uttar Pradesh. And the first one was announced from Chennai to Bengaluru. This is the first defense industrial corridor as announced by Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. Which state government has recently signed a memorandum of understanding with Tao Yuan City of Taiwan for better technology partnership? Taiwan's capital is Taipei. And mutual cooperation MOU has been signed between Telangana and Taiwan. Telangana, there is a festival called Batukamma, and Telangana, the state animal is deer. Don't confuse it with musk deer. Musk deer is the state animal of Uttarakhand, and don't confuse it with swamp deer. Swamp deer is the state animal of Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Telangana's capital is Hyderabad. Chandrasekhar Rao is the CM. KT Rama Rao is the IT minister, and capital is Hyderabad. Scientists have discovered a new plant species called Dripetes kalami. They have named it after APJ Abdul Kalam, the great scientist, to honor him. It is called Dripetes kalami. Where have they discovered it? Now, this was found at two places. One is Baksa Tiger Reserve and second is the Jaldapara Tiger Reserve. And both Baksa and Jaldapara are in West Bengal. West Bengal state animal is fishing cat. Fishing C-A-T cat. And Mamata Banerjee is the CM. Kesari Nath Tripathi is the governor of West Bengal. Capital is Kolkata, city of joy. Also remember that there is another called Goru Mara National Park, which is in West Bengal. And there is one more, which is called Neora Valley. Don't confuse Neora Valley National Park of West Bengal with Kangar Valley, which is in Chhattisgarh, or with Silent Valley National Park, which is in Kerala. These are the important ones. Who will co-chair? There is a Niti Forum that has been made by the Niti Aayog, and this Niti Forum is responsible for boosting the inclusive growth in northeastern region, that is 8 states. So who is the chairman? It is chaired by two people, Rajiv Kumar, who is the vice chairman of Niti Aayog, and also Jitendra Singh. Jitendra Singh is a cabinet minister. So answer is 1 and 4. Which state has launched something known as Nivesh Mitra. Nivesh basically means investment. Mitra means your friend, investment friend, Nivesh Mitra, to become the first state in India to enable clearing of projects in a digital manner. This state is Uttar Pradesh and they have replaced Udyog Bandhu with Nivesh Mitra. Udyog means industry and Bandhu is like your brother. So basically Udyog Bandhu was the old one. They have replaced it with a new one. Now in Uttar Pradesh, there is something known as Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary, and there is also a very important national park. In fact, it is the only national park in Uttar Pradesh called Dudhwa National Park. And it has Naroda Atomic Power Plant also. Ram Nayak is the governor. Yogi Adityanath, whose original name is Ajay Bisht, Ajay Singh Bisht. He was born in Uttarakhand, but now he is the CM of Uttar Pradesh. Capital of Uttar Pradesh is Lucknow. Unique Identification Authority of India, UIDAI, it has announced to introduce a Bal Aadhaar, which means Aadhaar card for the babies or for very, very young. For children below the age of what? If your age is less than 5 years, then you need to enroll yourself in Bal Aadhaar. And the color of the Aadhaar card is blue. Bal Aadhaar is blue in color. But also remember, when the child becomes 5 years old, you know, when he reaches 5 years, then he has to undergo a biometric update. And when he reaches 15 years of age, then there will be another biometric update. So there will be two biometric updates, one at 5 years of age, one at 15 years of age. Actress Sridevi passed away. She was from which state? She was a great actress. She was in fact a Padma Shri winner and she was from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has two important nuclear power plant. One is called Kalpakkam and the second one is called Kundankulam. And why Tamil Nadu was in news? It was in news for two reasons. And both reasons are related to Theni district. There is a district right at the border of Kerala and Tamil Nadu called Theni. In Theni, there were number one forest fire. Okay, there was a huge forest fire in Theni which burned down lakhs of trees. And the second reason is because in Theni, we are building something known as India Neutrino Observatory Project. And it is in news because only 5 kilometers away, we have Mathiketan Shola National Park in the Idukki district of Kerala. And therefore, the animals, they can get harmed by the harmful radiations from the neutrino observatory. That is why it was very difficult for it to get the environmental clearance. That is why Tamil Nadu was in news. Assam government has decided to celebrate Rhino Day on which date? See, rhino is the state animal of Assam government, one horned rhino. And it is found in Manas National Park and Kaziranga National Park also. So, September 22nd will be celebrated as Rhino Day by the government of Assam. Jagdish Mukhi is the governor. Sarbanand Sonowal is the CM of Assam. There is a dance also called Bihu. Capital is Dispur. And there is Dibru Saikhova National Park, Sonai Rupai National Park, Nameri National Park. And there is a Bar Nadi Wildlife Sanctuary. Bar Nadi, okay. There is Brahmaputra River in Assam. That also you remember. There is a Majuli Island, which was declared a district. And Majuli is the largest river island in India. There is Garam Pani Wildlife Sanctuary. There is Bar Nadi Wildlife Sanctuary. There is Am Chang Wildlife Sanctuary. There is Nameri National Park. Dibru Saikhova, Sonai Rupai, Manas. You know, so many. So, any question can be asked from Assam. How many medals did India win at the 69th Strandja Memorial Boxing Tournament that was held in the capital of Bulgaria, Sofia? And who is he? He is Vikas Krishnan. Vikas Krishnan is awarded the best boxer of the tournament. India won a total of 11 medals. So out of 11 medals, 5 were won by men and 6 were won by women. India won 2 gold medal, 3 silver medal and 6 bronze medal. Total 11. And the gold medals were won by Vikas Krishnan and Amit Fangal. And silver was won by Mary Kom, Gaurav Solanki and Seema Punia. You need to remember the names of only gold medal winner. Mary Kom is 5 times world champion, 5 times Asian champion and 1 time Olympic bronze medalist. She is from Manipur. And another woman famous from Manipur is Irom Sharmila. Irom Sharmila. And yeah, that's all. Which state has signed an agreement with Microsoft to improve the integration of technology to upgrade the education quality in the state? This has been done by the government of Tamil Nadu. They have teamed up with Microsoft. Now remember, Microsoft CEO is Satya Nadella. He is an Indian. He is from Hyderabad. And Google CEO Sundar Pichai is also from India. And Adobe, the famous company. You must have heard about Adobe Acrobat Reader, Photoshop and all that. So Adobe Shantanu Narayan is also an Indian. These three are the most important Indian CEOs. A regional center for agriculture is going to be set up in collaboration with Israel in which state of India? It will be set up in Mizoram. Mizoram CM is Mr. Lal, Thanhauwala, something, I can't remember the name. And he is from Congress. There are only four places in India where we have Congress government. We have in Punjab, Karnataka, Pondicherry and Mizoram. Punjab, Karnataka, Pondicherry and Mizoram. I hope I am not missing any. And Mizoram capital is Aizwal. And there is Dampa National Park in Mizoram. India recently began the 8th joint military exercise called Lamitye with which country? So from this country, we have recently got the permission to dock our military base at Assumption Island. Now you must have guessed the country. It is Seychelles Island. And there is another island called Chagos. Chagos Island we are getting from Mauritius. Chagos. Which state government has signed an agreement with Virgin Group to build a Hyperloop? Hyperloop can have very high speed, up to 1000 miles an hour or 1000 kilometers an hour. And it's not a train, it's basically Hyperloop. It has a principle of magnetic induction, and all these principles are applied. Lot of the levitation technology and all that are applied to create very high speeds in vacuum. So it will be built from Mumbai to Pune, and it is Maharashtra. And the chairman of Virgin Group is Richard Branson. Richard Branson, whose autobiography is called Losing My Virginity. Maharashtra CM is Devendra Fadnavis. There is a dance also called Lavani. And giant squirrel is the state animal of Maharashtra. There is Jaitapur and Tarapur nuclear power plant also in Maharashtra. Capital is Mumbai. And remember that the first Hyperloop was supposed to be built between Vijayawada and Amaravati in Andhra Pradesh, not in Maharashtra. So this is in fact the second Hyperloop project. So we have so far finished February 4th week. Okay. Now I'm starting with March MCQ. Mr. Ratnaval Pandian, he passed away. He was associated with what? So he was former judge of the Supreme Court, and he was also the chairman of National Commission for Backward Classes. He was from Tamil Nadu. So he was associated with law. And our Chief Justice of India is Deepak Mishra. He is the 45th Chief Justice. And these are some important people who expired. This is called obituary. Expect two questions from this. Shammi, she was an actor. Sarath Mohanty, actor from Odisha. Narendra Jha, actor who had acted in movies like Rais, Kabil and so on. M.K. Bhargav, he was an administrator. He was a former chairman of Madhya Pradesh Cricket Association. Sir John Sulston was a biologist, known for Human Genome Project. Shivaji Das Gupta was a broadcaster, commentator. He used to do commentary in the football games. T. Thomas was a businessman. He was the former chairman of Hindustan Unilever and Business Standard. Linda Brown was a civil rights activist. Sir Ken Dodd was a comedian from UK. Remember, Stephen Hawking, the famous physicist, was also from UK. David Astori was a footballer from Italy. He was a captain of Florentina team and he was only 31 years old. C.H. Kamalamma, freedom fighter from Telangana. Ranjana Roy, journalist. Sunil Sharma, journalist. Les Pine, journalist, was a Pulitzer Prize winning journalist from America. This is one of the biggest prize for journalists. Ghulam Muhammad Mustafa was a journalist. D. Sridevi was a jurist. She was a former Kerala High Court judge. C. Min Woo, musician from South Korea. Stephen Hawking, physicist from UK. Kedarnath Singh was a poet and he was a Gyanpith and Sahitya Academy Award winner. Now remember, Sahitya Academy Award is given in 24 languages. Okay. Whereas in our 8th schedule of the constitution, we have only 22 languages. So two extra languages are there, which are Rajasthani and English. Jayendranath Chaturvedi, he was the first commissioner of police of Delhi. You need to know these also. Prabodh Panda, politician. Khagendra Jamatia, politician from Tripura. Pantanagrao Kadam, politician. He was a Congress leader from Maharashtra. Begum Hamida Habibullah, politician. Former Rajya Sabha member from Uttar Pradesh. Javed Abidi, he was a civil rights activist. Civil liberties, he used to fight for civil liberties for people with disabilities. Chang Jae Sung, shuttler, badminton player from South Korea. He was a former world number one player. Aravinda Muduli, singer from Odisha. Pyare Lal Vadali, he was the younger brother of Puran Chand Vadali. Together they are called Vadali brothers, very famous singers from Punjab. And the son of the elder brother, Puran Chand Vadali, is Lakhvinder Vadali, who is also a very famous singer. T.R. Chandradat, social activist. Kanakalata Mohanty, writer from Odisha. Penny Vincenzi, writer from Britain. Prafulla Das, writer from Odisha. Emily Nasrallah, writer from Lebanon. Capital of Lebanon is Beirut. M. Sukumaram, writer Malayali. Malayali is a language of Kerala. Suresh Seth, mayor of Indore. Indore is the cleanest city of India. As per the cleanliness survey, it is Number 1 is Indore, number 2 is Bhopal, number 3 is Vishakhapatnam. Kalyan Singh Chauhan, politician, BJP MLA from Rajasthan, member of Legislative Assembly. Bhanu Shastri, politician. TSR Subramaniam, very, very important. He was cabinet secretary and he was also, there was a TSR Subramaniam committee that was made to upgrade the status of education in India. He was chairman of that committee. He was a bureaucrat. Billy Graham, evangelist from America. Kunwar Bai, I told you already, mascot for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, 106 years old woman from Chhattisgarh who sold her goats to build a toilet. Nilab Mishraf, journalist. Mangal Lal Shah, politician. He was a BJP MLA from Uttarakhand. So I hope these are not too many. Do some revision, you will easily learn. No big deal. Which state's cabinet has approved death penalty for rapist of girls below the age of 12? So that depends whether you want to ask which is the first state, second, third, fourth. So far, only four states in India, they have passed law. If there is a rape of any girl below the age of 12, then even a provision of death penalty is there. So first state to do so was Madhya Pradesh, second Rajasthan, third Haryana and fourth Arunachal Pradesh. Only these four states have done so. Shankaracharya Jayendra Saraswati, he was the 69th pontiff of which mutt? This mutt was founded by His Holiness Adi Shankaracharya in the 8th century. Very, very prestigious mutt. So this was the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham in Kanchi mutt. Kanchi mutt. And now his place will be taken by Vijayendra Saraswati. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, it has approved the continuation of Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program, which is called PMEGP, for an outlay of 5500 crore rupees for next 3 years. Till what? This scheme will be continued till 31st March 2020. So the answer is 2019-20. We are talking about financial year. Whenever we write a year like this, we mean 1st April of the first written year and the 31st March of the last written year. And also remember, urea subsidy has also been extended till 31st March 2020. Which team won the Vijay Hazare Trophy? We are talking about cricket. So Karnataka won it and they beat Saurashtra. Which Indian para swimmer, which means differently abled swimmer, has been suspended for 3 years by the Paralympic Committee of India? He was doing a mischief. He was recording videos of female swimmers at the National Swimming Championship in Jaipur. His name is Prasanta Karmakar. Employees Provident Fund Organization has introduced UAN Aadhaar Linking Facility in which app? This app is called Umang app. Now your universal account number Aadhaar linking can be done on Umang app. Which company has announced to buy Ring? Company name is Ring. It is a doorbell maker company. This company has been acquired for a whopping 6500 crore rupees, which is $1 billion. So Amazon has acquired, one of the biggest acquisitions of Amazon. And Jeff Bezos right now is the richest person in the world and richest person in the history also, as announced by Bloomberg. And he is the founder of Amazon. International Tennis Federation has proposed to transform which of the following tournaments into a 18 country World Cup of Tennis. This tournament is the oldest tournament in lawn tennis. It was started in the year 1900. It is called Davis Cup. Which country's membership has been reinstated by International Olympic Committee? Reinstated means it was banned and now the ban is uplifted. So it is Russia. Russia was banned from the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics of 2018. Shipping Minister Nitin Gadkari, he recently laid the foundation stone for setting up of a national technology center for ports, waterways and coasts. Remember, Nitin Gadkari is the minister for road transport, highways. He is also the minister for Ganga rejuvenation, water, water resources, river development. He is also the minister for shipping. So he has his hands full. So there will be a national technology center for ports, waterways and coast at which place? This is at IIT Chennai, set up at an investment of 70 crore rupees. Which state government has announced to set up a state Sanskrit education council? He is the deputy chief minister of this state and also the education minister. His name is Manish Sisodia and I'm talking about Delhi. Delhi state animal is Nilgai. It's a union territory, by the way. Which space agency has announced to set up a lunar habitat on moon by sending robot and 3D printer? Who will send robot and 3D printer on moon? It is ISRO. And Chandrayaan 2 mission will take place later now, or earlier it was supposed to take place in April, but now I believe it will take place somewhere in October. And it is called Indian Space Research Organization. And K Sivan is the chairman of ISRO. It is headquartered in Bengaluru. And ISRO's mission for studying sun is called Aditya L1 mission. NASA is American Space Agency, National Aeronautical Space Agency of America, headquartered in Washington, D.C. Remember, NASA also conducted two missions. One was called Cassini. Cassini mission was for Saturn. And another one was called Juno. Juno was for Jupiter. And then we have SpaceX, which is Elon Musk's private space agency, SpaceX. Their rocket is called Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy. JAXA is Japanese Aeronautical Exploration Agency. And remember, there is a rocket called Long March, which is a rocket of Chinese National Space Agency. Who has been honored with Sportsman of the Year at the Laureus World Sports Award 2018? Remember that Laureus, for the first time in India, they have their brand ambassador. His name is Yuvraj Singh. Yuvraj Singh is the first ever ambassador for Laureus. And Laureus Sportsman of the Year male is Roger Federer. He is 20 times Grand Slam winner. This year he won the Australian Open also. He is from Switzerland. And the female award, that is Sportswoman of the Year, went to Serena Williams. She is also from lawn tennis and she is from America. Lifetime Achievement Award was given to Edwin Moses. And Team of the Year went to Mercedes. They won the Formula One Championship, if you remember. Lewis Hamilton and Valtteri Bottas and all those. So Mercedes was the Team of the Year. Also, there was a special award which was given to Francesco Totti. He plays football. He used to play football for Italy and AS Roma Football Club. Special achievement was given to him. Which institute has developed a website and a mobile app called Marine Fish Sales to help the fisherman community sell fish directly to customer? It is developed by the Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute. India has successfully conducted the test of which anti-tank guided missile in Pokhran, Rajasthan? This missile is called NAG. It is developed by DRDO, Defense Research Development Organization, and the chairman of this is Dr. S. Christopher. Dr. S. Christopher is the chairman of DRDO. Who has been appointed the National Goodwill Ambassador for Pakistan by UNDP, United Nations Development Program? She is the first woman from Pakistan to climb Mount Everest. Her name is Samina Baig. Pakistan's capital is Islamabad. Prime Minister is Khaqan Abbasi, who was in news because he was frisked at the United States airport. And Pakistan, we have Sindh, capital is Karachi. And we have Pakistan, Punjab, capital is Lahore. There are two trains that run from India to Pakistan. One is called Samjhota Express. One is called Thar Link Express. And we have a Gwadar port in Pakistan, developed by China. And now they are making another port at place called Jiwani. Okay, so this is a military base that China is trying to build. There is a China-Pakistan economic corridor also, which goes from Gwadar to, you know, Xinjiang province, Kashgar. Which state is going to host the 13th edition of India-Nepal joint exercise called Surya Kiran? Surya Kiran will be hosted at Pithoragarh. Pithoragarh is where? Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand has the second highest number of tigers in India after Karnataka. Uttarakhand has Rajaji Tiger Reserve and Jim Corbett Tiger Reserve. And Uttarakhand CM is Trivendra Singh Rawat. On his life, there was a book that was launched recently called Khaira Sen Ka Suraj. Khaira Sen Ka Suraj. That was the name of the book. It was a biography of Uttarakhand CM. And governor is KK Paul. Capital is Dehradun. And state animal is musk deer. It also has World Heritage Sites like Nanda Devi and Valley of Flowers, etc. Who is going to become the youngest captain in the history of the international cricket? His name is Rashid Khan. He is captain of Afghanistan. Afghanistan president is Ashraf Ghani. Kabul is the capital. The line between, the border between Pakistan and Afghanistan is called Durand Line. Vinay Kumar has been appointed as India's ambassador to which country? He is India's ambassador to Afghanistan. And Ravi Thapar is India's new ambassador to Panama. Sangeeta Bahadur, Belarus. Capital of Belarus is Minsk. It's a European country. Atul Gotsurve, DPRK. DPRK means North Korea. M. Subaraidu, Bolivia. Bolivia has two capital. One is called Sucre. One is called La Paz. If in exam you get both options, then mark Sucre. Who launched viral load testing for all the people living with HIV/AIDS? So his name is JP Nadda. He is the health minister. Anupriya Patel is the minister of state in the Ministry of Health. And Preeti Sudan is health secretary. And India's target to eliminate HIV/AIDS is 2030, tuberculosis 2025, and malaria 2027. Our Union Cabinet was recently informed about the MOU on renewable energy with which country? With which country we have signed Memorandum of Understanding on renewable energy? India's renewable energy target is 175 gigawatt by 2022. This country is Fiji. Capital of Fiji is Suva, and there is a golf player also from Fiji, very popular, called Vijay Singh. Name is Indian, he is of Indian origin, but he is from Fiji. And these are the MOUs which I have tabulated. So with Fiji, we have signed in the field of renewable energy. Vietnam, capital is Hanoi, in the field of economic and trade cooperation. Macedonia is the birthplace of Mother Teresa, the saint from Kolkata. So in the field of health, capital of Macedonia is Skopje. Jordan, capital is Amman, we signed in the field of manpower. Mauritius, capital is Port Louis, in the field of information technology for competitive exams. Hellenic Republic, in the field of renewable energy. Hellenic Republic is the name of a country. With France, we have signed in the field of all these, you know, migration, mobility, partnership, sustainable urban development, nuclear power, hydrography, maritime cartography, and so many. Iran, we have signed for traditional system of medicine like Ayurveda, homeopathy, Unani, Siddha, yoga, and all that. Sri Lanka, in the field of information technology and electronics. Guyana, in the field of renewable energy. Zambia, judicial cooperation. SSCEP, oil and chemical pollution, how to tackle this. UK and Northern Ireland, organized crime, how to control it. Canada, IPR, intellectual property rights, IT, energy, higher education, startups, and sports. Bangladesh and Russia for civil nuclear cooperation. This is for Rupur nuclear power plant that is being built in Bangladesh. Rupur. Hong Kong, double taxation avoidance agreement. Hong Kong, Qatar, and Kenya, all the three. Uzbekistan, pharmaceutical. And remember, Department of Pharmaceutical comes not under the Ministry of Health, but it comes under the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizer. And with Germany for building smart city. And already Germany is building Kochi, Coimbatore, and Bhubaneswar as smart city in India. Kochi, Coimbatore, Bhubaneswar. Kochi is in Kerala, Coimbatore is in Tamil Nadu, Bhubaneswar is the capital of Odisha. What is India's rank out of 86 countries on the Inclusive Internet Index that was given by Facebook? Facebook COO is Sheryl Sandberg. And CEO is Mark Zuckerberg. Recently, it was in news because of Cambridge Analytica. There was a data breach. India is ranked a very poor 49. And number one country in this is Sweden. Which lake's annual monitoring report has said that this lake contains highest number of Irrawaddy dolphins in the world? Now remember, Irrawaddy is a river in Myanmar. That is why these dolphins are named Irrawaddy. Okay. And this lake is Chilka Lake in Odisha. It is the largest lagoon lake in India, saltwater lake. And Odisha also has Mahanadi. There is a Mahanadi water dispute between Odisha and Chhattisgarh. And Odisha CM is Naveen Patnaik. Party name is Biju Janata Dal. And governor of Odisha is Satyapal Malik. He is also the governor of Bihar. Now old governor of Odisha, S.C. Jamir, has retired. And therefore, Satyapal Malik has been given the additional charge of Odisha. The ceremony for Tapi pipeline was held recently, and you can see all the important stakeholders here. Which gas field in Turkmenistan will feed this pipeline? It is the Galkanish field in Turkmenistan. It is the world's second biggest gas field. And in the photo, you can see Turkmenistan President Mr. Karbanguly Berdi Mukhamedanov, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani. You can see Pakistan PM, Kakan Abbasi, and you can see MG Akbar, who is the Minister of State in the Ministry of External Affairs. From Galkanish, it will go to Afghanistan, Herat and Kandahar. Then it will go to Pakistan in Quetta and Multan. Then it will end in Fazilka in Punjab. This is called Tapi Pipeline. How much amount has been allocated to Indian Institute of Technologies, IITs in India, out of the 1 lakh crore corpus under the RISE scheme? RISE stands for Revitalizing Infrastructure and Systems in Education Scheme. The highest amount, in fact, has been given to IITs. It is 25,000 crores. To central universities, government has given 20,000 crore. To NITs, National Institute of Technologies, like NIT Suratkal, NIT Gandhinagar, and so on. NITs, we have given 11,300 crore. IIMs, where you can do MBA, 4,500 crore. and IISER, Indian Institute of Scientific and Education Research, 5000 crore. So highest allocation has been given in fact to the IIT. Education comes under Ministry of HRD, Human Resource Development, headed by Prakash Javadekar. First conference of International Solar Alliance was held where? Remember, International Solar Alliance headquarters is in Gurugram in Haryana. But the first conference took place in New Delhi. It was attended to by French President Mr. Emmanuel Macron also. Because at COP21 Paris Agreement Climate Conference, International Solar Alliance was made with the effort of both PM Modi and the then President of France, Francois Hollande. Which country has declined India's invitation to join Milan Naval Exercise? It is a multilateral exercise hosted by Andaman Nicobar. This country is Maldives. India-Maldives relations are at an all-time low because Maldives declared an emergency and India kind of went against it and they supported the ex-president Noshiad, instead of Abdul Qayyum. And so basically the relations are very poor right now. And also China has intervened in this and China has offered to mediate a talk between the opposition and the Supreme Court and the ruling government. So India's place, which was supposed to be India's, was taken by China. And the capital of Maldives is Malé. Which state government has announced a 5 lakh health cum life insurance scheme for the farmers? This state is Telangana. Telangana has announced a 5 lakh rupee scheme for farmers. Minister of Drinking Water and Sanitation Uma Bharti recently launched the Swajal pilot project at which location? She launched it at a village called Bhikampura. Now Bhikampura is a village in Rajasthan. Vasundhara Raje is the CM and Kalyan Singh is the governor of Rajasthan. He is a ex-CM of UP, by the way, Kalyan Singh. And Rajasthan capital is Jaipur, Pink City. We have Sariska National Park. We have Ranthambore National Park. We have Bharatpur or Keoladio National Park. We have Rawat Bhata Nuclear Power Plant. All this is in Rajasthan. Which ministry has launched an idea competition called Srijan? Srijan has been launched by the Ministry of Railways. What is the full form of Srijan? It is called Station Rejuvenation Initiative through Joint Action. Who is our railway minister? Piyush Goyal. He is also the minister for coal. And remember, railways has started something known as Project Saksham. Saksham. Saksham basically means able in English. And Project Saksham is to do the skill development of 1.3 million railway employees. And there is another project called Operation Swarn. S-W-A-R-N. Swarn means gold in English. And Operation Swarn is basically to upgrade the services in Rajdhani, Shatabdi and all the luxury trains. World Rare Disease Day. It was recently observed on which date? It was observed on February the 28th. And this time the theme was research. These are the important days in the month of March and in the last week of February. 24th February, Central Excise Day. 28th February is World Rare Disease Day. As I said, theme is research. 28th February, one more day, National Science Day. This time the theme was Science and Technology for a Sustainable Future. 1st March is the Zero Discrimination Day. 1st March is also the Civil Accounts Day. 3rd March is the World Wildlife Day. Write like this, wildlife W, right? So you kind of twist it, rotate it, it becomes 3. So 3rd March is the World Wildlife Day. The theme was Big Cats. Big Cats are your tiger, lion, puma and leopard and all these. Big Cats, predators under threat. 8th March is International Women's Day. The theme was The Time Is Now. Rural and urban activists transforming women's lives. 8th March is also the World Kidney Day. Kidney and women's health include value empower. 14th March, Pi Day. Pi, the value of pi is 22/7. If you do calculation, this is 3.14. And this is basically 14th March, right? Month is 3 and date is 14. 14th March is Pi Day. There was a movie also called Life of Pi. 11th March is Less Traffic Day observed in Bengaluru. This was the second time it was observed. 16th March was World Sleep Day. The theme was Join the Sleep World, Preserve Your Rhythms to Enjoy Life. 15th March is World Consumer Rights Day. The theme was Making Digital Markets Fairer. 21st March is also the day for Elimination of Racial Discrimination. The theme was Promoting Tolerance, Inclusion, Unity and Respect for Diversity in the Context of Combating Racial Discrimination. 21st March is also the International Day of Forest. India's forest cover has increased by 1% in the last 2 years. And our Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change is Dr. Harshvardhan. He is also the Minister for Science and Technology and also for Earth Sciences. So Forest and Sustainable Cities is the theme. 21st March is International Navroz Day, said to be the new year. 20th March is the World Sparrow Day. And 21st March is the World Down Syndrome Day. Because Down Syndrome happens due to abnormality in the chromosome number 21. That is why 21st March is the World Down Syndrome Day. Some more days for you. 21st March is World Poetry Day also. 18th March, Global Recycling Day. 20th March, one day before poetry, we have Happiness, International Day of Happiness. The theme is Share Happiness. 24th March is the International Day for the Right to the Truth Concerning Gross Human Rights Violations and for the Dignity of the Victims who are basically, who suffered because of the human rights violations. 23rd March is the World Meteorological Day. The theme was Weather Ready, Climate Smart. 22nd March is the Bihar Foundation Day, the Foundation Day for the Bihar state. 22nd March is also World Water Day. The theme was Nature for Water. 23rd March is Martyrs Day because Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev, they were hanged by the British on this day. 24th March is World Tuberculosis Day. The theme was Wanted, Leaders for a TB-Free World. 20th March is Birak Foundation Day. The theme is Sustaining Innovation, a Market-Driven Pathway. 25th March is the International Day of Solidarity with Detained and Missing Staff Member. 14th April is National Social Justice Day. It must have been in news, that is why I've covered here. 27th March is World Theatre Day. 25th March is International Day of Remembrance of the Victims of Slavery and the Transatlantic Slave Trade. And the theme was Remember Slavery, Triumphs and Struggles for Freedom and Equality. So I hope you had a good time mugging up all the days. How much amount of loan has Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? This bank, China has the maximum share in this bank, followed by India. And in 2017, the maximum loan by this bank was given to India. It was $1 billion. And this year, Infrastructure Investment Bank has promised to give a loan of $1.5 billion. And last year, number one recipient was India. Number two was Indonesia. So Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, don't confuse it with Asian Development Bank. Asian Development Bank, India has fourth highest share. In AIIB, India has second highest share. AIIB is headquartered in Beijing. ADB is headquartered in Manila. AIIB, and there is another bank called New Development Bank, headquartered in China in Shanghai. And AIIB president is Jin Likan. Jin Likan is the ex-finance minister of China. These are some important loans given by various banks to India. $80 million loan given by Asian Development Bank for Youth Employability Project in Himachal Pradesh. $1.5 billion loan promised by Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank headquartered in Beijing, infrastructure related projects in India. 150 million euros European Investment Bank has promised for clean energy projects. $120 million Asian Development Bank for improving rail infrastructure in India. And $84 million loan by Asian Development Bank again for water supply projects in Bihar. And these are the loans which are given by India to other countries. So India is giving a loan of $100 million to Mauritius for defense capacity building. $80 million loan to Madagascar, capital is Antananarivo, for agriculture and mechanization of agriculture. That is using machines in agriculture to improve efficiency. $5 million USD to UNRWA for Palestine refugee welfare. Palestine capital is East Jerusalem. $500 million loan to ECOWAS Bank for investment and development for developmental projects in 15 member countries. Total there will be 27 projects. Railway Ministry has announced to install sanitary napkin dispenser and incinerator at how many railway stations by International Women's Day on March of 8th. So there will be 200 railway stations on which sanitary napkin vending machines will be put. Remember, Bhopal railway station was the first railway station in India where sanitary napkin vending machine was put. And recently, Suvidha sanitary napkin has been launched by the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizer. It cost only 2.5 rupees. Which institute has entered into a memorandum of understanding with RSTT of the Indian Ocean Rim Association for designating Central Institute of Medicinal and Aromatic Plants, which is present in Lucknow? They want it to be a coordinating center for medicinal plants. Medicinal plants are like your basil, which is called Tulsi, right? Which can be used for your ailments like Ashwagandha, like Sarpagandha. You know, all of these are medicinal plants. This institute is CSIR. And also remember who is the Director General of CSIR, Dr. Girish Sahani. And RCSTT stands for Regional Center for Science and Technology. Our Civil Aviation Minister, please remember the then Civil Aviation Minister, Ashok Gajapati Raju, because he was from Telugu Desam Party. Now they have broken their ties with the BJP, and that is why the new Civil Aviation Minister is Commerce Minister Suresh Prabhu. He has been given the additional charge of the Ministry of Civil Aviation. He recently inaugurated India's first multi-skill development center at which place? This was done in the capital of Punjab and Haryana. It is called Chandigarh. It's a union territory. Who has won the Aravindan Puraskaram? Aravindam Prize for the best debutant director of 2017. This award was started in memory of the Malayalam filmmaker G. Aravindan. His name is Mr. Sagar Chaya Vanchari. Employees Provident Fund Organization has made it mandatory now. If you want to withdraw your Provident Fund, you have to do it online, provided it is more than how much. So if you want to withdraw more than 10 lakh rupees, then it has to be done only online. This is a condition. Which country has been put into the grey list or will be put into the grey list in June 2018 by the Financial Action Task Force? So even Saudi Arabia, China, they did not help this country this time because of the pressure of America. This country is Pakistan. Pakistan, because of money laundering and terrorism activities. And also remember, China has been made the vice president of FATF. Which country has recently allowed women to join military for the first time? This country is Saudi Arabia. Capital is Riyadh and currency is Rial. King Salman. King is Salman. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved a proposal to double the guarantee of NAFED to, which is basically the Cooperative Marketing Society for Indian agriculture, to help it obtain higher credit from bank. Earlier, NAFED could, let's say NAFED could loan X amount. Now it has been made 2X. Now they can take a credit up to 19,000 crore rupees from the banks. Their limit has been doubled. Which state government has launched a mobile governance mobile app called T App Folio? Here T stands for Telangana. So it is Telangana. Capital is Hyderabad. KT Ramarao is the IT minister. And all of these are his brainchild only. Earlier, they had also launched something known as T Hub for entrepreneurs, and recently V Hub for entrepreneurs. So that also you can remember. And they gave Urdu language the status of their second official language after Telugu. Who led the Indian delegation? So there was a 20th conference of the Commonwealth Education Ministers that was held in Fiji at a place called Nadi. Who represented India at this 20th conference? India was represented by Dr. Satyapal Singh. He is a Minister of State in the Ministry of HRD. Don't confuse him with Dr. Satyapal Malik. Satyapal Malik is the Governor of Bihar and Odisha now. Satyapal Singh is the Minister of State in HRD Ministry, and HRD Minister is Prakash Javadekar. Ministry of Defense, they have begun the process to set up India's first defense industrial corridor, where India's first defense industrial corridor is being set up in Tamil Nadu. And second in Uttar Pradesh. Which institute has discovered methane gas in the Krishna Godavari basin? So Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri, they all fall into the Bay of Bengal and they all form delta. Krishna Godavari basin methane gas has been found by the National Institute of Oceanography at Donapola. Union Cabinet has approved a bill to allow which agency now that can investigate human trafficking cases? Earlier, this agency's mandate was not to probe human trafficking cases. It is the National Investigating Agency, NIA. They passed the Trafficking of Persons Prevention, Protection and Rehabilitation Bill. Who took oath as the Chief Minister of Tripura? Tripura's capital is Agartala, and the state animal of Tripura is something known as Fire-Ace Langur. And there is something known as a Gumti Wildlife Sanctuary in Tripura. There is also Rowa Wildlife Sanctuary in Tripura. And this person is Biplab Kumar Dev. Also remember the previous Chief Minister. He was Manik Sarkar. 25 years he ruled in Tripura. And Governor is Tathagat Roy. And Deputy CM is Jishnu Dev Barman. Remember, Manik Sarkar was the poorest Chief Minister in India. Armen Sarkisian, he is elected as the new president of which country? Sarkisian. So this country is Armenia. Armenia's capital is Yerevan. And the outgoing president is Sergey Sarkisian. Sergey Sarkisian has resigned. Capital is Yerevan. And the currency of Armenia is Dram. World's largest solar park called Shakti Sthal. It was recently launched where? So it was launched in Tumkur district. Where is Tumkur? It is in Karnataka. So the answer is Karnataka. And remember that in Tumkur there is a village called Pavagada village where this largest solar park has been installed. Its capacity is 2000 megawatt. India's target is 175 gigawatt of renewable energy, and out of that solar power will be 100 gigawatt by 2022. Reserve Bank of India has announced to remove the per borrower loan limit for classification under the priority sector lending. So banks have to shell out a loan to agriculture, education, micro, small, medium enterprises. These are all priority sectors, right? So it is around 40%. And for micro and small, earlier the limit was only 5 crore. And for medium, it was 10 crore. Now this limit has been done away with. That is why the banks can give more loans now to the MSME sector. MSME minister is Giriraj Singh. Who won the Tal Memorial Rapid Chess title that was held in Moscow? His name is Vishwanathan Anand. He's from Tamil Nadu and he is 5 times world champion. Also remember, he recently won the World Rapid Championship also. And there is a player called Bhaskar Nadiban. He had won the Reykjavik Memorial, which was held in the capital of Iceland, which is Reykjavik. Which team won the IBSF Snooker Team World Cup that was held in the capital of Qatar, Doha? Now remember, Doha will host the 2022 football, FIFA Football World Cup. It was won by Pankaj Advani. Pankaj Advani everybody knows, but who is this person? His name is Manan Chandar. Manan Chandar. So the answer to this question is India. Also remember, India beat Pakistan in the final. Which state government has launched Khushi scheme to provide free sanitary napkin to school girls? Khushi scheme has been started by Odisha, and this will be done in all the government and government aided schools. Similar scheme called SheePad was started by Kerala to provide free sanitary napkin to the girls who are studying in the schools. And very similar scheme called Stri Sakhi. Sakhi means friend. Okay, Sakhi is your friend, and Stri means woman. So Stri Sakhi scheme was started by the government of Goa. And very similar scheme, Asmita Yojana. Asmita scheme started by the government of Maharashtra. These are all sanitary pad napkin schemes. I've written here, Khushi by Odisha, She Pad by Kerala, Asmita Yojana by Maharashtra, and Stri Sakhi by Goa. Who has been awarded Lifetime Achievement Honor at London's House of Commons? So in the UK's parliament, there are two houses, lower house and upper house. So in India, we have lower house Lok Sabha, upper house Rajya Sabha, and in lower house, you know, there it is called House of Commons, and upper house is called House of Lords. So House of Commons, they gave Lifetime Achievement Award to great actor Shatrughan Sinha. Which union minister has launched the social media of, there is a magazine called Namaste Shalom. Who launched it? This is a magazine on India-Israel relation. Like in India, we say Namaste, in Israel, we say Shalom. So it was launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh. And this gentleman is Tarun Vijay, who was sworn in as the next Chief Minister of Nagaland. Previously also, he has been the Chief Minister of Nagaland 2 times. So his name is Nephew Rio. His party is People's Democratic Alliance. This alliance is between the BJP and NDPP. And governor is Padmanabha Acharya of Nagaland. There is a festival in Nagaland called Hornbill Festival, which is very, very popular. And there is Intanki National Park also, near Intanki River. And Mithun is the state animal of Nagaland, also of Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland both have Mithun. Mithun is, looks just like a buffalo. Okay, it's a hilly buffalo, so to say, mountainous buffalo. Yeah, that's all. The Silver Jubilee of which festival was recently celebrated in Itanagar? This festival is the Losar Festival. And Arunachal Pradesh CM is Pema Khandu. And there is Nam Daf National Park. And there is Mauling National Park. Now, there is a place in Arunachal called Changlang. 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 Why was it in news recently? Can you write in comments? Which film won the Best Film Award at the 90th Academy Award, also called Oscar Award? This film is The Shape of Water. And who has directed it? His name is Guillermo del Toro. He is from Mexico. So I've written here. And he got the Best Director Award. Guillermo del Toro for The Shape of Water. Best Actor was given to Gary Oldman for the film Darkest Hour. He played the role of Winston Churchill. Best Actress, Frances McDormand for 3 Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. Best Screenplay, Get Out, Jordan Peele for the movie Get Out. Best original score, The Shape of Water, Alexander Desplat. Best foreign language film is A Fantastic Woman from Chile. And best animated cartoon feature film is Coco. Which state government has launched a mobile video van? Scheme name is Amagaon Amavikas. Amagaon Amavikas program. It has been launched by the government of Odisha. Naveen Patnaik is the CM. Party name is Biju Janata Dal. There is Bhitarkanika National Park in Odisha. This is in the Mahanadi Delta area region, Bhitarkanika National Park. There is also Gahirmat Beach. Gahirmat Wildlife Sanctuary is also there. And this beach is famous for the olive ridley turtles. And there is Chilka Lake also here. And there is something known as a Satkosia Tiger Reserve. Satkosia Tiger Reserve, which was in news. Which space agency recently launched world's most advanced weather satellite, which goes by the name GOES-S? This is a satellite of NASA and their rocket is called Atlas V rocket. Atlas V. Who has become the first Indian woman to win a gold medal at the Senior Asian Wrestling Championship? What is her name? Her name is Navjot Kaur. And this was held in the capital of Kyrgyzstan, which is called Bishkek. Bishkek. And Sakshi Malik won bronze medal and Vinesh Fogat is world number 2 now. He won the silver medal. And Navjot Kaur is also world number 2 now. Scientists from which city? They have developed a compound called silver copper telluride, AgCuTe, which can turn waste heat into electricity. So this has been done by scientists from Bengaluru, from the Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research. Which space agency has signed an agreement with China on lunar exploration? Both Chinese CNSA and this space agency will do lunar exploration. They have signed it with Roscosmos, which is the Russian space agency. A book reading event was held at which place? And this broke the Guinness World Record. Here 7,000 people, they read books simultaneously, all at one place. It is called Gadchiroli. It is in Maharashtra. And it is very important because it is a Naxal affected area. So if book reading events can take place in such areas, it's a good thing. As per the Conservation Assured Tiger Standards Survey, how much percent of the tiger conservation areas, which are essentially tiger reserve areas, they met the global standards of an accreditation system? You'll be surprised, only 13%. Only 13% of the tiger conservation areas, they met the global standards. This survey was done on 112 sites in 11 countries. 70% of the world's tigers are in India. Maximum tiger in India are in Karnataka, followed by Uttarakhand. Maximum elephant in India are in Karnataka, followed by Assam, followed by Kerala. Which state's local bodies department? They have signed a memorandum of understanding with Electronic Governance Foundation for managing electronic governance of urban local bodies. Urban local bodies, they want to digitize themselves, they want to manage themselves electronically, and this decision has been taken by the government of Punjab. Captain Amrinder Singh is the CM of Punjab, VP Singh Badnor is the governor, and capital is Chandigarh, and they also started something known as a Care Companion program recently. Care Companion program. There is also a wetland in Punjab called Roper. Roper wetland. Which Indian shooter won the gold medal with a world record score in the 10 meter air pistol event at the ISSF World Cup that was held in Mexico's Guadalajara? His name is Shahzar Rizvi. Shahzar Rizvi. And Jitu Rai and Mehul Ghosh, they won bronze match medal each. But the story of the tournament was Manu Bhakar. She is only 16 year old girl and she won two gold medals. Two gold medal, one in individual event 10 meter pistol and one in the team event of 10 meter pistol. Manu Bhakar, don't forget this name. Central government has approved establishment of NFRA. So for CAs, chartered accountant, this will be an oversight body. This will see the working of the auditors. NFRA stands for what? It stands for National Financing Reporting Authority. National Financial Reporting Authority. There will be 15 members in this authority, one chairman and 3 full-time members. Government has constituted a steering committee on fintech financial technology related issues. Who is the chairman of this committee? Chairman is Subhash Chandra Garg. Subhash Chandra Garg. Which country is going to launch world's first legal tender cryptocurrency? And this cryptocurrency, they have called it Sovereign. It is Marshall Island. And capital of Marshall Island is Majuro. Majuro. Also remember, Venezuela was the first country to launch a cryptocurrency named Petro in crude oil. Petro, and Petro has been banned by America now. Venezuela currency is Bolivar, the national currency, and their capital is Caracas. It is a South American country and Nicolas Maduro is the president. India has become the fastest growing economy in the world. In the third quarter, what was their growth? What was India's growth? India's growth was 7.2% and China's growth was 6.8%. So we have become the fastest growing economy. Third quarter stands for October, November, December 2017. Which Indian origin Scotland Yard officer has been appointed as the counter-terrorism chief? He is an Indian, therefore this question is very important. His name is Neil Basu. Scotland is a part of UK. In UK, there are four countries: Scotland, Wales, England, and Northern Ireland. Not the Republic of Ireland, Northern Ireland. Northern Ireland capital is Belfast. Ireland capital is Dublin. England capital is London. Wales capital is Cardiff. Scotland capital is Edinburgh. And there is another important city in Scotland called Glasgow. Very, very popular. Who broke the world record in the 50 meter freestyle event? World record in the 100 to 104 years men's master category. He is an Australian swimmer. He reminds me of Ian Thorpe from Sydney Olympics, if you remember. His name is George Coronis. As per the data released by the National Payment Corporation of India, out of all the UPI transactions that took place in 2017, this company did 40% of those. Which company I am talking about? I am talking about Paytm. Paytm. And 171 million transactions took place through Paytm. Also remember, Paytm founder is Vijay Shekhar Sharma and the parent company of Paytm is called 197 Communications. There is a Paytm payment bank also and the managing director for the same is Renu Sati. Minister of Food Processing Industries, Harsimrat Kaur Badal, she recently inaugurated Maharashtra's first mega food park at which place? This was the 12th mega food park in India. It was opened in Satara. She is a Lok Sabha MP from Punjab in Bhatinda. As per the global firepower list, at what rank has India military prowess been ranked among 133 countries? India, the most powerful military is America, then Russia, then China, and fourth is India. India's military has 13,62,500 active personnel. Krishna Kumar Kohli, she has become the first ever Hindu Dalit woman senator in which country? She has become in Pakistan and her party is Pakistan People's Party. It is a party of Bilawal Bhutto Zardari. Which state government has launched a 2000 rupees crore universal health scheme of their own? This has been done by the government of Karnataka and they are promising free treatment up to 1.5 lakh rupees for each BPL family and also 30% of the bills amount up to 1.5 lakh of the APL, above poverty line family. So basically they will pay 1.5 lakh rupees to BPL or APL and they have called it Arogya Karnataka. Karnataka CMA Siddaramaiah, there is Banargatta Bandipur Nagarhole National Park. There is also BRT Wildlife Sanctuary, Kudremukha and Dandeli Reserves, Tiger Reserves. So all these are important protected areas in Karnataka. What is the name of the new malware virus detected by the cyber security agencies which can take over electronic devices and use them as bots? So basically what this virus will do is, if you have a mobile phone, it will completely take over the mobile phone. It will then force the mobile phone or the laptop to do ping on the server. And by repeated pinging, it will crash the server. So this is called Saposhi. Very, very dangerous. And this type of attack is called DDoS. They can ask you the full form of DDoS. It stands for Distributed Denial of Service. Which institute is going to conduct a national sizing survey to come up with a standardized India size chart for the garment industry? So basically in India, we don't have the concept of M, L, XL. It is there, but it is not standardized. So now National Institute of Fashion Technology, NIFT, wants to standardize this process by doing a national sizing survey. Mascot for which of the following games was released recently? So it is the Tokyo Summer Olympics 2020. And there are two mascots. This one, pink, is for Paralympics and this is for the normal Olympic, Summer Olympic. So this is called blue and this is called pink. Who has resigned? He was the chairman of the Board of Control for Cricket in India, BCCI, Junior Selection Committee. He has resigned as the chairman. Why he has resigned? Because he is now the bowling coach of Kings 11 Punjab IPL team. And you very well know how much money is there in IPL. His name is Venkatesh Prasad. Shigmotsav festival was celebrated where recently? This is a festival from Goa. It is celebrated one day after the Holi festival. India recently signed a three-party agreement with which country for civil nuclear cooperation? India signed it with Bangladesh and Russia, and this is for making of Rupur nuclear power plant in Bangladesh. As per Hurun Global Rich 2018 list, what is India's rank in terms of highest number of billionaires in the world? Maximum number of billionaires in the world is in China, second is America, and third is India. Third is India. Which team won the Interstate National Tennis Championship 2018 that was held in Chhattisgarh? So who is the national tennis champion? National tennis champion is Maharashtra. Which space agency is launching TESS, which is called Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite? Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, it is SpaceX. CEO of SpaceX is Elon Musk. Recently, they also placed a Roadster car inside their Falcon Heavy rocket. Who has taken oath as the new chief minister of Meghalaya? Meghalaya's chief minister is Conrad Sangma. His party is National People's Party. He will replace Mukul Sangma. And governor of Meghalaya is Ganga Prasad. Meghalaya is famous for Khasi, Garo and Jayantia hills. There is a place called Cherrapunji which receives heavy rainfall. Near Cherrapunji, we have a place called Mohsen Ram where the highest ever rainfall has been recorded in history. And Meghalaya has Nokrek National Park also. And also remember, Meghalaya state animal is clouded leopard. Don't confuse it with snow leopard. Snow leopard is the state animal of Himachal Pradesh. Which state and union territory they have recently joined Ujjwal Discom Assurance Yojana Uday scheme, which is basically to infuse a new lease of life into the debt-ridden, the power distribution companies, which are called DISCOMs. Now, Lakshadweep has joined it. Also remember, there are only two states out of 29 which have not joined it, Bengal and Odisha. They have not joined, rest all the states have joined the Uday scheme. How much amount of funds central government has allocated for the second phase of Imprint India program? Imprint stands for Impacting Research, Innovation and Technology. The amount is this time 1000 crore. This is significant because earlier for the phase 1, the amount was only 318 crore. So they have made it more than 3 times. What is the name of the association of all the Indian metro rail companies launched recently to create a knowledge pool? All the metro rail companies, they have come together, coalesced into one organization which is called iMetro. iMetro. And also remember that Lucknow Metro is the first metro to have their own FM station. Who has become the first woman to be inducted as a direct entry combat officer by the Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force? It is headed by R.K. Pachananda. R.K. Pachananda is the Director General of Indo-Tibetan Border Police Force, which guards our border with China. Now remember, Border Security Force, it guards our border with Pakistan and Bangladesh. Then there is Sashastra Seema Bal, SSB, which guards our borders with Bhutan and Nepal. And there is Assam Rifles, which guards our border with Myanmar. So her name is Prakriti. She is from Bihar, Samastipur district. Which state's power utility? They have started something known as a pink electricity zone, which will be managed only by the women staffer. This is for women empowerment. 25 women staff will be here. It is in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh was also the first state to start something known as a happiness department. Anandiben Patel is the governor of Madhya Pradesh. Also, you should know two or three wildlife sanctuaries of Madhya Pradesh since we are talking now about the state. There is Kanha National Park. There is Panch National Park, Panna National Park, there is Bandhavgarh National Park, famous for tigers. There is also Van Vihar National Park. Don't confuse Van Vihar with Govind Pashu Vihar. Govind Pashu Vihar is in Uttarakhand, Van Vihar is in Madhya Pradesh. Shivraj Singh Chauhan is the CM of Madhya Pradesh. And now let's come to wildlife sanctuary. So there are three more most important ones. One is called Orcha Wildlife Sanctuary. It is in Tikamgarh district. Then we have Narsinghgarh Wildlife Sanctuary and Ghatigaon Wildlife Sanctuary. Which state government they have launched their own flag? They have become the second state in India after Jammu Kashmir to launch their own flag. It is Karnataka. Haryana's first cyber police station was recently opened where? It was opened in Gurugram, which is the headquarters of International Solar Alliance. And recently, World Design University was opened in Haryana in Sonipat district. World Design University. Also, there is Kalesar National Park in Haryana. And there is Sultanpur National Park. Which Indian origin man has been selected for Pride of Birmingham Award? Birmingham, we will have 2022 Commonwealth Games. So his name is Harry Atwal. Why he has been given this award? because during Barcelona terror attacks, he saved lives of many people. Which ministry has launched Sukhad Yatra, which means Happy Journey app? Sukhad Yatra stands for Happy Journey in English. It is launched by National Highway Authority of India, Road Transport and Highways. Minister is Nitin Gadkari. National Highway Authority of India is headquartered in New Delhi, and it is the organization responsible for building state highway and national highways in India. But remember, the highways at the borders and at mountains are built by Border Road Organization, and its headquarters is also in New Delhi. Animal Welfare Board of India, they have shifted their headquarters from Chennai to where? They have shifted from Chennai to Ballamgarh. Ballamgarh, the new name of Ballamgarh is Balramgarh, and it is in Haryana. In Haryana, there is also something known as Chilchila Wildlife Sanctuary. Chilchila Wildlife Sanctuary is in Kurukshetra, the same place where the Battle of Mahabharata was fought. And Haryana's capital is Chandigarh. Kaptan Singh Solanki is the governor. Manohar Lal Khattar is the chief minister of Haryana. Which state government has approved the proposal for home delivery of wheat, rice, whatever the ration you get under the PDS, public distribution system? It has been started by Delhi government. Arvind Kejriwal of the Aam Aadmi Party is the CM. Anil Bajal is the governor. And also remember, Neel Gai is the state animal of Delhi. Who has been appointed by Uber as their first ambassador in India? He is Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli and Uber, Dara Khosrow Shahi is the CEO of Uber. Dara Khosrow Shahi. Uber's main competitor is Ola, and Ola Bhavish Agarwal is the CEO. Bhavish Agarwal. And these are some latest brand ambassadors from the month of March. Virat Kohli has been made brand ambassador for Luminous Powers Amaze, MS Dhoni for online game called Dream 11, and UK's industrial cadet program, they have made Sanjeev Gupta their brand ambassador. Vivo mobile phone company from China have made Amir Khan, and Educate Girls, Katrina Kaif. What is the name of the sanitary napkin launched by the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizer, and he is the minister for the same, Anant Kumar? It is called Suvidha. It is 2.5 rupees per sanitary pad, available in a pack of 10 rupees for 4 napkins. Which union minister has been given the additional charge of the Ministry for Civil Aviation? He is Suresh Prabhu, the Minister for Commerce and Industry, because Ashok Gajpati Raju, his party, Telugu Desam, has broken their ties with BJP. Which state government has approved setting up of a Center of National Medicinal Plants Board? This is to promote the growth of the medicinal plants. It has been done by the government of Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh has Pin Valley National Park. Don't confuse it with Kangar Valley of Chhattisgarh or Neora Valley of West Bengal or Silent Valley of Kerala. Now, why Silent Valley is called silent is because it does not have the tree insect or the kikada insects which produce sounds during the night. So it is always silent. So Himachal Pradesh, Jairam Thakur is the CM, Acharya Devrat is the governor. The state animal is snow leopard, and there is a great Himalayan National Park also in Himachal Pradesh. Capital is Shimla. Central government has approved continuation of Swatantra Sainik Samman Yojana, which is called SSSY, till which date? It is 31st March 2020, the same date for the extension of urea subsidy. It is also till 31st March 2020. They will spend 2,552 crore rupees on the same. Which team won the I-League? We are talking about football. It is their first title. It is Minerva Punjab Football Club. Who has been recognized by Queen Elizabeth II as the 26th Commonwealth Point of Light? Because she has done a lot of work in empowering women. She is the founder of something known as a Cross Bow Miles Movement. Her name is Srishti Bakshi. Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, they have announced a fund of how much for women's economic empowerment in 4 countries, India, Kenya, Tanzania and Uganda. So they will give $170 million. Remember, Kenya's capital is Nairobi, Tanzania is Dodoma, Uganda is Kampala. Don't confuse Uganda with Rwanda. Rwanda's capital is Kigali. Both are African countries. Kenya and Tanzania are also African countries. India is of course Asian country. Tanzania is famous for Mount Kilimanjaro, which is the highest mountain peak in Africa. Ministry of Finance has directed the banks. It has given clear directions to banks to collect passport details of customers who want loan of above how much. If you want a loan of 50 crore or more, then you will have to submit your passport details. This is to prevent you from leaving the country. And this is to be done within 45 days. Institute of Bioresources and Sustainable Laboratory, IMFAL. It has set up a floating laboratory on which lake? This lake is Loktak Lake. It is in Manipur. CM is Biren Singh. And Sangai is the state animal of Manipur. Now remember, it is not India's first floating laboratory. The first floating laboratory was set up on Brahmaputra River in Assam, and second is of course on the Loktak Lake. Who has been appointed as the new director of PIB? I'm sure you are enjoying PIB analysis every day by Prashant Mamani. His name is Sitanshu Kar. Prime Minister Modi recently announced National Nutrition Mission and expansion of the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign at which place? This place is Jhunjhunu. It is in Rajasthan. And remember, in National Nutrition Mission, we want to reduce the low birth weight phenomena and the malnutrition phenomena by 2% every year. And we also want to reduce the stunting from 38.5% to 25% by 2022. This is our target. America has recently conducted joint military exercise Operation Juniper Cobra with which country? They have done it with Israel. Israel Prime Minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. The Teen Murti Marg in New Delhi has been named after the city of Haifa. Jerusalem is the capital. Shekel is the currency of Israel. And Hebrew, in which the Holy Bible is written, is the language of Israel. And Reuven Rivlin is the president. Who has resigned as the chief economic advisor to the US President Donald Trump? His name is Mr. Gary Cohen. Gary Cohen has resigned. And who has he been replaced by? He has been replaced by Larry Kudlow. Larry Kudlow is now the chief economic advisor. And remember, national security advisor, General HR McMaster, he is replaced with John Bolton. John Bolton is considered a hawk, which means he is pro-war. He wants war with every country. Secretary of State or Foreign Minister was Rex Tillerson, replaced by Mike Pompeo. Mike Pompeo earlier was the director of the CIA. And now he has been replaced with Gina Haspel, who is the first ever woman chief of CIA. Chief strategist was Steve Bannon, replacement is being found as we speak. And communication director and veteran affairs secretary are also replaced. Now you don't need to remember communication director, veteran affairs secretary and chief strategist. You need to remember, however, NSA, secretary of state, chief economic advisor and CIA director. These four are extremely important. Who has become the first Indian architect to win the prestigious 45th Pritzker Prize? He is 90 years old. His name is Balkrishna Doshi. This is considered the Nobel Prize of Architecture. Central government has increased the dearness allowance for the central government employees from 5% to what? They have increased from 5% now to 7%. Who has become the first person with more than 100 billion fortune to top the Forbes annual ranking of the world's richest people? World's richest person is now Jeff Bezos, founder of Amazon. Warren Buffett is the founder of Berkshire Hathaway Company. Berkshire Hathaway. Mark Zuckerberg is CEO of Facebook. Bill Gates of Microsoft. Bill Gates and Paul Allen, they founded Microsoft together. Paul Allen. Remember, Bill Gates and Paul Allen founded Microsoft. Reserve Bank of India has imposed a penalty of 5 crore rupees on which payment bank? It was flouting rules. This is the Bharti Airtel Payment Bank. It was also opening the payment bank account of people without their permission, without their consent, by their eKYC Aadhaar number data breach. So this is the penalty on all the banks. These are in the month of March. State Bank of India fined 40 lakh rupees for violation of counterfeit currency norms, fake notes. They were not following the rules and regulation regarding the same. Airtel Payment Bank was opening unauthorized accounts. 5 crore rupees penalty. Axis Bank, headed by Shikha Sharma. State Bank of India chairman is Rajneesh Kumar. 3 crore rupees penalty for violation of non-performing asset norms. Indian Overseas Bank fined 2 crore rupees for violation of the KYC norms. And ICICI Bank fined 59 crore rupees for sale of HTM portfolio, held to maturity portfolio. Which union minister recently flagged off the national e-mobility program? India wants to have 100% electronic cars by 2030. So he is RK Singh, Minister for Power and Renewable Energy. Which airport has been called the best among the airports which handles more than 40 million passengers per annum by the Airport Council International Survey, ACI survey? See, if they ask you which is the best airport in the world, then the answer is simple: Changi Airport in Singapore. Okay. Which is the busiest airport in the world? The answer is Dubai Airport. Which is the busiest airport in the world with a single runway? The answer is Mumbai Airport. Which is the best airport in the world with more than 40 million passenger per annum category? The answer is Indira Gandhi International Airport. So I hope you can now answer all the four questions. GAIL India, Gas Authority of India Limited, it's a Maharatan company. There are 8 Maharatan company in India, and the 8th Maharatan company was Bharat Petroleum, BPCL. It is the latest company to be accorded Maharatan status. GAIL India has signed a 3.5 million ton per annum liquefied natural gas agreement with which country? GAIL India has signed it with America. Also note, with America, we are buying shale oil from America for the first time in the history. It is a petrol, and it will be transported to Paradweep Port, which is in Odisha, on the eastern coast of India. What is the name of the new state of matter created by the scientist by filling a giant atom with ordinary atoms? It is called Rydberg polaron. See, there is solid, liquid and gas. And there is something known as a Bose-Einstein condensate. Bose-Einstein condensate. There is plasma. Some people regard plasma as the fourth state of matter and Bose-Einstein condensate as fifth state of matter. I mean, these are not official. Officially, we have only three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. Now there is a new state of matter called Rydberg polaron, in which we have taken a giant atom and filled it with ordinary atoms using weak bonds at very low temperatures. Also remember, Bose-Einstein condensate also happens at very low temperatures. What is the name of the organization India has become a member of, and India is the 69th member. India has become the member of European Bank for Reconstruction and Development, called EBRD. It is headquartered in London. And remember that the president of this bank is Suma Chakrabarti. Suma Chakrabarti. And this bank was set up in 1991. Which state has become the first in America to pass a law which mandates net neutrality? Net neutrality is a concept where, you know, that says that no internet traffic should get special treatment. It is Washington in America. How much amount of penalty has Competition Commission of India put on Jet Airways, Interglobe Aviation and SpiceJet? Before this, it had also put a penalty on Google also for search bias. Now it has put penalty on these three airlines worth 54 crore rupees. How many gold medals did India win at the Archery World Cup that was held in Bangkok? India won 3 gold and 3 bronze. They are asking here gold medal, so the answer is 3. Which of the following has signed a memorandum of understanding with CSC Electronic Governance Services for its Udyami Mitra portal? Udyami Mitra is a portal of the government of Uttar Pradesh. They have replaced something known as Udyog Bandhu, and the organization is SIDBI, Small Industries Development Bank of India. And Mohammad Mustafa is the chairman of this bank. Also remember, SIDBI is headquartered in Lucknow. Don't confuse it with SEBI. SEBI is headquartered in Mumbai and it is a capital market regulator headed by Mr. Ajay Tyagi. ONGC Videsh, it has recently signed an agreement with IDRO Oil for developing Susan Gerd oil field at which place? Susan Gerd oil field will be developed in Iran. In Iran, Chabar port we are building, which is also called Shahid Behesti port. Capital is Tehran. Hassan Rouhani is the president, who was also on a visit to India. Which portal has been launched by the Micro Small Medium Enterprise Ministry for women entrepreneurs? It is called Udyam Sakhi. Udyam Sakhi. MSME minister is Giriraj Singh. Which country has recently declared an emergency because of the clashes, riots between Muslims and Buddhists? This country is Sri Lanka. And this took place in the Kandy district of Sri Lanka. Sri Jayawardenepuri Kotte is the capital of Sri Lanka. And also remember, Ranil Wickremesinghe is the prime minister. And Maithripala Sirisena is the president. And also remember that recently in held elections, local elections in Sri Lanka, Mahendra Rajapakse, he won the election. So it's not a good news for India, because Mahendra Rajapakse can very well become the next prime minister of Sri Lanka, and he's pro-China. The program Vision for Future, it was recently held in New Delhi to commemorate 70 years of our diplomatic ties with which country? This is our all-weather friend, Russia. Capital is Moscow. Currency is ruble. There is a place called Red Square in Russia. And Vladimir Putin is the president. He has become the president for 6 more years. And American president is selected for 4 years. Russian president for 6 years. And India and China president is selected for 5 years. Elected for 5 years. And just like there is a Red Square in Russia, there is a Tahrir Square in Egypt. There is a Times Square in New York, America. And there is a Trafalgar Square in London. So there are a lot of important squares in the world. What is the name of the exercise that was conducted by the Eastern Naval Command? The Indian Navy has 3 commands. Okay, one is Eastern, one is Western, one is Southern. There is no Northern Naval Command, because in North India we don't have an ocean, right? So Eastern, Western and Southern. Now, Eastern Command conducted the exercise ENCOR. ENC stands for Eastern Naval Command Operational Readiness Exercise, to check how ready are we for any operation. And Eastern Naval Command is headquartered in Vishakhapatnam. Western Naval Command is headquartered in Mumbai. Southern Naval Command is headquartered in Kochi, Kerala. Okay. And there was an exercise conducted by Western Naval Command recently, which is called Pashchim Lehar. Pashchim in English means west. Pashchim Lehar. Which state has been awarded Nari Shakti Puraskar, which means woman power? Nari Shakti Puraskar by the Ministry of Women and Child Development, headed by Maneka Gandhi. Which state I am talking about? It is Punjab. Who has been named as the chairman of Mahanadi Water Dispute Tribunal that will try to resolve the dispute, Mahanadi water dispute between Odisha and Chhattisgarh? His name is Justice A.M. Khanwilkar. Also remember, there is a Mandovi River dispute between Karnataka and Goa. Karnataka and Goa. In Goa, it is called Mandovi. In Karnataka, it is called Mahadai River. And there is a Kaveri dispute, the forever Kaveri dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Recently, there was a Supreme Court verdict after which Tamil Nadu is not happy because Karnataka has got more water. Government has approved a proposal to institute something known as Home Minister's Medal for Excellence in Police Investigation. This is to encourage our people ranging from sub-inspector to our, you know, all these higher rank officials who do police investigation. These awards will be given once in every how many years? These will be given once in every 3 years. There are total 162 medals that will be given. Our Minister for Home Affairs is Rajnath Singh, who headed the executive committee meeting held under the Poshan Abhiyan. Under Poshan Abhiyan, it was Rakesh Srivastava who headed the committee. Rakesh Srivastava is secretary in the Ministry of Women and Child Development. How many countries recently signed CPTPP? This is nothing but the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Earlier, there were 12 countries. America backed out. Now, there are 11 countries. So, basically, they will decrease the import and export duty by up to 90%, 95%. And this is basically a free trade agreement. So, the countries like Australia, Canada, Chile, New Zealand, Peru, Singapore, Vietnam, and many countries, they have signed this agreement. The meeting took place in the capital of Chile, Santiago. Which institute won the 2017 Cochon Prize for its work in the tuberculosis research and development? India's target to eliminate tuberculosis is 2025, malaria 2027, HIV/AIDS 2030. Also remember, WHO's target to eliminate malaria is 2030. India's target to eliminate malaria is 2027. There are four types of malaria: Plasmodium malariae, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium ovale vivax. These are the four types of malaria. So the answer to this question is Indian Council of Medical Research. Which country won the Best Exhibitor Award at the International Tourism Festival ITB Berlin? The Ministry of Tourism is headed by this gentleman who is receiving the award. His name is KG Alphonse. He is from Kerala, but right now he is a Rajya Sabha member from Rajasthan. And to our Tourism Minister is KG Alphonse and Culture Minister is Dr. Mahesh Sharma. The Ministry of Tourism has launched a scheme called Prasad for pilgrimage cities development, under which 25 cities will be developed. This is called Pilgrimage Rejuvenation and Spiritual Augmentation Drive. And there is another scheme called Swadesh Darshan, which is launched to augment tourism in India. So the answer is India. Which state has been announced to host the 80th edition of the National Table Tennis Championship after a gap of 12 years, announced by the Table Tennis Federation of India? This is Odisha. Odisha will host the National Table Tennis Championship. Which bank has launched the scheme called Vikas She Plus for women entrepreneurs? And this scheme is that you can get a loan up to 2 lakh rupees and you can pay in a span of 5 years, 60 months. This is the Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. India's tallest national flag was recently unfurled where? It was unfurled at Belagavi. It is in Karnataka. This flag, pole, you can see the pole here and this is the flag. So pole is 110 meter and the height of Kutub Minar is 72 meter. So it is even taller than the Kutub Minar, right? And the area of the flag is 9600 square feet. How much amount of credit is India giving to 15 countries for 27 solar projects? Because India is one of the leaders in the International Solar Alliance. India is giving a loan of $1.4 billion. And another leader is France, right? So France is giving a loan of 700 million euros. Who has become the first Indian woman to be given the Academy Award for Nobel Peace? Her name is Dr. Katzia David Prakasam. She is from Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. Which country was the leading medal winner? That is, it topped the medal tally at the ISSF World Cup that took place in Guadalajara in Mexico. The country that topped was India. India won 4 gold, 1 silver, 4 bronze, total 9 medals. So the answer is India. The gold medal winner were Shahzar Rizvi, who is in the picture here. Also Manu Bhakar, Akhil Sheron and Om Prakash Mitharwal. Who has been announced to be FMSCI National Motorsports Person of the Year? The Lifetime Achievement Award was given to K.D. Madan and Motorsport Person of the Year is Anandit Reddy. First time There is a stretch on India's border with which country? It has become a crime-free zone. India border with Bangladesh is now a crime-free zone. Bangladesh, we have two trains from India to Bangladesh. One is called Maitri Express and another is called Bandhan Express. And with Pakistan, there are two trains, Thar Link Express and Samjhota Express. Bangladesh PM is Sheikh Hasina and their currency is Taka, capital is Dhaka. What is the name of the humanitarian and disaster relief exercise that was conducted by the Indian Air Force in association with the South Asian region countries in Kerala? What is the name? The name of this exercise is Samvedna, and a lot of countries participated like Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Nepal, even UAE. Which country launched their hypersonic missile called Kinzhal? Very, very powerful. They launched this from MiG-31. So whenever the word MiG comes, understand it is always Russia. President Ramnath Kovind, he is the 14th President of India, and Venkaiah Naidu is the 13th Vice President of India. Okay, so they inaugurated, Ramnath Kovind inaugurated the World Hindi Secretariat building at which location? He launched it in Mauritius. Capital is Port Louis. This is for the promotion of Hindi language on a global scale, at least in Mauritius. And we are getting an island from Mauritius called Chagos. Remember that the World Hindi Day is celebrated on 10th of January, whereas National Hindi Day is celebrated on 14th of September. There is a difference, right? World Hindi Day, 10th of January, National Hindi Day, 14th of September, and on 15th of September, we have the National Engineers Day. Who has been honored with the Godavari Gaurav Award by Kusumagraj Pratishthan? Godavari is a river which takes its origin from Nasik in Maharashtra, and his name is Amol Palekar. He was a great actor and a great director. Haryana government has constituted a committee which is basically regarding the supply of water from Yamuna River, which flows in Delhi, Agra, some part of UP, etc. It takes its origin from Yamunotri Glacier in Uttarakhand, and then it merges with Ganga in Allahabad. So the committee is headed by OP Dhankar. European Investment Bank is giving a loan to India Renewable Energy Development Authority to finance the clean energy projects in India. How much loan are they giving to us? They are giving 150 million euros. Who won the women's category senior national triathlon championship that was held in Vishakhapatnam? It was won by Samira Abraham from women's side, and men's was won by Bishwarjeet Singh. Which cricket team won the Deodhar Trophy title that was held in HPCA Stadium in Dharamshala, Himachal Pradesh, which is the highest stadium in India? So India B won it, and they beat Karnataka. As per the World Bank's report, India Development Update, India's economy will grow in 2018-19 at what percent? India's economy will grow at 7.3%, and in 2019-20, it will grow at 7.5%. World Bank is headquartered in Washington, D.C. Even International Monetary Fund is headquartered in Washington, D.C. Together, they are called Bretton Woods twins. And World Bank's president is Jim Yong Kim. SpiceJet company recently made their first commercial flight at the Pakyong Airport. Where exactly is Pakyong Airport? It is in Sikkim. Sikkim's CM is Pawan Kumar Chamling. It is the first organic state of India, and it is the first open defecation free state of India. And capital is Gangtok. It also has Mount Kanchenjunga, which is 8,598 meters in height. What is the name of India's biggest media and entertainment services market that was inaugurated by the Commerce Minister Suresh Prabhu? It is called ENT Tech. Home Ministry has sanctioned to set up India's first National Academy of Coastal Policing at which location? This will be done in Gujarat. Now, if they ask where in Gujarat, so this will be in Dwarka district. Which union territory has become the first union territory in India to be 100% solar energy efficient? It is Diu. However, it is very small. It has a geographical area of only 42 square kilometer. There is a new species of a Himalayan moth, which is called Euceloides gavissima. It has been discovered recently where? It has been discovered in Papikonda National Park in Andhra Pradesh. In Andhra Pradesh, you also have something known as a Koringa Elephant Reserve. Koringa. Which country has approved a plan to abolish presidential term limit, allowing its president to stay in power indefinitely? Now, earlier, only two terms were possible for a president, that is 10 years. 5 years into two terms. Now, Xi Jinping can stay indefinitely as president. Which of the following recently celebrated 33rd Inception Day and launched a mobile app which is called Citizen Services? It was launched by the National Crime Record Bureau. They celebrated their 33rd inception day. And the director of National Crime Record Bureau is Dr. Ish Kumar. Which state's forest department has launched an app to track and fight the forest fire? This has been launched by the government of Odisha. Forest fire are very common in Uttarakhand and also in Himachal Pradesh. What was the theme of the 9th Women Film Festival that was organized by the National Film Archives of India? The first movie that was shown here was called Out of Africa. And the last movie that was shown is called Eat, Pray, Love. Eat, Pray, Love. The theme this time was Traveling Women. Which country recently unfurled the world's biggest flag? This flag is 200 kilometers long. Believe it or not, yes. This country is Bolivia. Now, there are two capitals of Bolivia. One is called Sucre and one is called La Paz. If in exam you get both, then mark Sucre. Which team won the 10th Sultan Azlan Shah Cup that was held in Malaysia's Ipoh? Capital of Malaysia is Kuala Lumpur. Malaysia truly Asia, as they say. And this country is Australia. Australia beat England. And third place went to Argentina. Which state government has set up something known as Mukhya Mantri Mahila Kosh? Mahila means woman, Kosh means fund, to basically provide pension to those unmarried women who are above 50 years of age. This state is Madhya Pradesh. What is India's rank out of 156 countries on the World Happiness Report? Are we a very happy country? Not exactly. We are 133rd. Happiest country in the world is Finland. It is ranked number 1. And the last, that is rank 156, is given to Burundi. Even Pakistan is happier than us. It is ranked 75. International Air Transport Association, it has signed a memorandum of understanding with the Rajiv Gandhi National Aviation University and the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Now you have to tell me where exactly is the Rajiv Gandhi National University. Where exactly is the Rajiv Gandhi National University? It is in Uttar Pradesh. Where in Uttar Pradesh? Rai Bareli. Rai Bareli is a Congress bastion. Which Indian film has won the Grand Prix de Montreal honor at the 21st Festival International du Film Pour Enfants de Montreal? Now, since I can speak French, don't try speaking this in French. Basically, this is Montreal Film Festival, right? And which Indian film was adjudged the best? This film is called Halka. Halka. And it is directed by Neela Panda. Neela Panda. Lok Sabha has passed the Payment of Gratuity Amendment Bill. Now, tax-free gratuity has been increased from 10 lakh to what? Gratuity is the money that you get from a company if you spend 5 years or more there as a gift from the employer. Since you showed loyalty and stayed at one place, earlier tax-free was up to 10 lakh, now it is 20 lakh. Which state government has proposed an insurance scheme for journalists and their families? This government is Assam government. Dispur is the capital. He is Hemanta Biswa Sarma and he is Sarbanand Sonowal, the CM. Lok Sabha recently passed the finance bill with how many amendments? There was no discussion, no debate. They used the guillotine provision to pass the bill. Together, a total of there were 21 amendments in the bill. And she is Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan. And the Deputy Lok Sabha Speaker is M. Thambi Durai. Which short film has won the Best Film Award at the Los Angeles Film Festival? This was a short film festival. The film is called Shunyata. And you can see Jackie Shroff is one of the actors in the movie. The director of this movie is Chintan Sharda. Reserve Bank of India has now disallowed the banks to use which of the following instruments as a trade credit for import? You know that Nirav Modi, he got the Punjab National Bank to issue LOUs and he borrowed money and he fled away. So LOUs can act as a guarantee. But now LOU and LOC, that is letters of comfort and letter of undertaking, have been revoked or they will never be used now. Reserve Bank of India has made it very clear. So 3 and 4 is the answer. Letter of undertaking and letter of comfort will not be used now. Instead, letter of credit can be used. Who won a bronze medal? This was a big race, 8-kilometer cross-country race. This was the 14th Asian cross-country championship that was held in China's Guiyang area. Her name is Sanjeevani Jadhav. Sanjeevani Jadhav. Which state government has approved to impose a ban on plastic carry bag and certain plastic items? This state is Maharashtra. They also observed something known as Marathi New Year, which was on 18th of March, also called Gudi Padwa. As per the SIPRI, Stockholm, which is capital of Sweden, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, which country is the world's biggest importer of weapons in the last 5 years? Out of all the weapons that were imported in the last 5 years, 12% have been bought by this country, and this country is India. Maximum weapons we have bought from Russia, then America, then Israel. which cricket board has recently launched a book to honor ex-president of BCCI, Jagmohan Dalmia? This honor has been given to him by launching a book called A Tribute to Jaggu. It is the board of Sri Lankan Cricket Board. World's largest theater festival, the 8th Theater Olympics, it will conclude where? It started from Red Fort in New Delhi and it will end at Gateway of India in Mumbai. So the answer is Mumbai. Mumbai also recently celebrated the Kala Ghoda Festival and the theme was Hara Ghoda. 15th Finance Commission, which was in news for all the wrong reasons because there are accusations it is leading to a north-south divide because it is trying to fix the state contribution by the center on the basis of population by using the 2011 census data. So who is the chairman of 15th Finance Commission? It will take effect from 1st of April 2020. The chairman is N.K. Singh. Niti Aayog has released the roadmap for sustainable action for transforming human capital in education, which is called Saath E. So the scheme called Saath is divided into two parts. One is called Saath E, one is called Saath H. So it is for healthcare and education. Now Niti Aayog selects two or three states and it tries to develop these states as a role model states for either education or healthcare. This time Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha are covered. Bihar is not covered thus far. United Nations Committee for Development Policy, which is called CDP, it has recommended that how many countries should be excluded from least developed country category because now they are sufficiently developed. These countries are four: Bhutan, Kiribati, also called pronounced as Kiribati, then there is Sao Tome and Principe and Solomon Island. So there are four countries. United Nations headquarters is in New York. UNICEF headquarters is also in New York. And Antonio Guterres is the chief of United Nations. He is from Portugal. As per the World Bank's India Development Update, what is the rank of India among 115 countries using GST in terms of the highest tax rate? You know that one of the slab in GST is 28%, right? This is the second highest in the world. What is the name of the program that is launched by the Ministry of Health to improve the quality of care in the labor rooms and maternity operation theater? This program is called Lakshya. This will decrease the neonatal mortality rate, infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, and so on. Which country has announced to withdraw from the International Criminal Court? They said there is discrimination against this country. He is the president of Philippines. His name is Rodrigo Duterte and capital is Manila, which is the headquarters of Asian Development Bank. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, it has recently approved urea subsidy scheme. Now urea subsidy scheme will be till 31st March 2020. So the answer is 2019-20. And the subsidy cost will be 1,64,935 crore rupees. The Minister for Water Resources, Nitin Gadkari, he is also the Minister for Road Transport, Water Resources, Ganga Rejuvenation, River Development, Mining, Shipping, lot of ministries. Mining, I don't think he is there, or maybe he is, but shipping definitely he is there. Then a lot of portfolios he has. So 5th Nadi Mahotsav was celebrated where? It was celebrated in Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh has two important rivers. One is called Narmada, one is called Tapi. Confederation of Indian Industry, CII. And who is the director of CII? Can you tell me? Director is Chandrajit Banerjee. It has announced to set up a multi-skill center at which place? This center is made in Darjeeling. Darjeeling is the leading producer of tea in India when it comes to cities. But it is not in Assam, it is in West Bengal. And Assam is the leading producer of tea in India when it comes to states. Ministry of Environment and Forest, it has given clearance to Indian Neutrino Observatory project to be set up where? It will be set up in Theni district in the Bodhi West Hills. And remember that Mathiketan Shola National Park is only 5 kilometers from here. It is in the Idukki district of Kerala. Who has been felicitated with the UK Golden Flame Award at the annual Tongue of Fire UK Asian Film Festival that was held in the capital of England, London? She is Simi Garewal, and Simi Garewal is also a famous actress. Asian Development Bank is giving a loan to India to improve the rail infrastructure. This loan is worth how much? The loan is worth $120 million. Scientists from which institute, they have for the first time cloned a Assamese buffalo male calf, and the name of this male calf is Sach Gaurav. Sach Gaurav. Remember that cloning is when you develop a carbon copy of your own. You know, when you develop a carbon copy of an animal, plant or anything, that is called cloning. So it is done by Central Institute for Research in Buffaloes called CIRB, ICAR, CIRB. ICAR is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. Which of the following has launched Umang app? This app is basically a lost and found app. If you leave anything at airport, you can find its details on this app. Now you know that airport security is provided by Central Industrial Security Force. So the answer is CISF. And who is the Director General of CISF? OP Singh. OP Singh. Which state has become the best performing state in the allocating of jobs and utilizing the funds under MNREGA? Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act, which give you a at least 100 days guarantee of work every year. This state is West Bengal. Pradhan Mantri Modi recently inaugurated the 105th Indian Science Congress. The theme was Reaching the Unreached Through Science and Technology. Minister for Science and Technology is Dr. Harshvardhan. This was recently done in capital of Manipur, which is Imphal. Imphal. Manipur University hosted it. Who has been removed as the Chief Justice of Nepal because he was faking his date of birth? Now, very, very interesting. His name is Gopal Parajuli. Vidya Devi Bhandari has been re-elected as the President of Nepal. And Thalga Prasad Sharma Oli, KP Oli, is the new Prime Minister of Nepal. Capital is Kathmandu, which is the headquarter of SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. And Amjad Sial Hussain is the President of SAARC. He is from Pakistan. There is a new species of this insect, which is called Tilomera Nagalanda, Jeha, Mehar and Chandra. It is found at which river? You can see Nagalanda. So the answer is Intanki River. Intanki National Park is also in Nagaland. Which country Supreme Court has disallowed the foreign companies and foreign lawyers from practicing in this country on a permanent basis? It is India. India has disallowed. What is India's rank among 114 countries on the World Economic Forum's Energy Transition Index? World Economic Forum annual meeting took place in Davos in Switzerland, attended by Pradhan Mantri Modi. It was after 20 years that Indian Prime Minister attended Davos meeting. Earlier it was actually Devegowda in 1997 that had attended it. India's rank is a very, very poor 78. Number one in this is Sweden. And World Economic Forum is headquartered in Cologne in Geneva in Switzerland. And World Economic Forum president is Klaus Schwab. Klaus Schwab. Which of the following has become the latest country to achieve the one-day status for the first time? This is given to recently Nepal. Now Nepal will also play one-day matches. FIFA, the football governing body headquartered in Zurich. FIFA has lifted 30 years football ban from which country? This country is Iraq. And FIFA's president is Gianni Infantino. The FIFA World Player of the Year award went to Cristiano Ronaldo this year. He also won the UEFA Best Player of the Year and Ballon d'Or award, which is given by the French magazine L'Equipe. Which Indian chess player has won the 33rd Reykjavik Open in Iceland? His name is Bhaskaran Adiban. Which Indian differently abled athlete, para athlete, has won the gold medal in the javelin throw in the World Para Athletics Grand Prix with a world record score? Her name is Deepa Malik. Which Indian shuttler badminton player has won the women's singles under 19 title at the Israel Junior 2018? It was held in Rishon LeZion. And Israel, we also had a magazine called Namaste Shalom, released recently by Dr. Jitender Singh. Her name is Purva Barve. Africa's only female head of state, Amina Gurib Fakim, she has resigned as the president of which country? This is the country Mauritius. Capital is Port Louis. Which team won the fourth Hero Indian Super League? It was won by Chennai FC and they defeated Bengaluru Football Club. Now remember that Sunil Chhatri, he was named as the hero of ISL, which means player of the tournament. Indian Navy has begun a bilateral exercise called Varuna with the Navy of which country? This was done with the Navy of France. Chemical and Fertilizer Minister Anant Kumar has announced to set up a plastic park. This will be set up by CIPET, Central Institute of Plastics Engineering and Technology. Where will it be set up? It will be set up in Deogad in Jharkhand. Now there is a Dalma Wildlife Sanctuary in Jharkhand and there is a Palamo Tiger Reserve, there is a Betala National Park, Draupadi Murmu is the governor, Raghubar Das is the CM. Remember one thing, don't confuse Dalma Wildlife Sanctuary in Jharkhand with Dampa National Park in Mizoram. It's a common mistake. Who has been announced by the Norwegian Academy of Science and Letters as the winner of the Abel Prize 2018? The Abel Prize is called the Mathematics Nobel Prize. It is given to the Canadian mathematician Robert Langlands. Which cricket team won the Irani Cup? Was won by Vidarbha. This cup has two teams. One is the rest of India and another is the winner of Ranji Trophy. Now you know that Ranji Trophy was won by Vidarbha. So Vidarbha also won the Irani Cup. They beat the rest of India team. One player from Vidarbha, very important, is Wasim Jafar. He made a record of scoring 18,000 runs in the first class cricket and he also scored highest ever score in the Irani Cup. World's last Northern white male rhinoceros called Sudan recently died in Laikipia National Park. Laikipia National Park is in which country? Laikipia National Park is in Kenya. Capital of Kenya is Nairobi. Who inaugurated 7th Women Science Congress? that was held at Manipur University in Imphal. It was inaugurated by this gentleman. He is Kesarinath Tripathi, governor of West Bengal, and CM of West Bengal is Mamata Banerjee. Party name is Trinamool Congress. Fishing cat is the state animal of West Bengal. Indian Coast Guard, they recently commissioned the ship called C-437 at which location? This was done in Porbandar in Gujarat. Porbandar is also the place where Mahatma Gandhiji was born. And they can also ask you, who is the Director General of Indian Coast Guard? He is Rajender Singh. Which of the following has received Pandit Dindyal Upadhyay Krishi Vigyan Protsahan Award? The Kandla Port in Gujarat is also named after Pandit Dindyal Upadhyay. This award went to Krishi Vigyan Kendra of Chhattisgarh. Who has resigned as the Prime Minister of Slovakia? Capital of Slovakia is Bratislava. I am talking about Robert Fico. Which state government has declared Lingayat community a minority religion distinct from Hinduism? It is the government of Karnataka. These are the followers of Basavanna. And remember that Kodavas are also demanding now separate religion status. Kodavas are from Kodagu, famous for coffee cultivation. Hatin Kayao resigned as the president of which country? He was president of Myanmar. Old name of Myanmar is Burma. There is a Irrawaddy River also in Myanmar. And capital is Naypyi Taw. Foreign minister is Aung San Suu Kyi. New president is Win Myint. Which country has prohibited the purchase of Venezuelan cryptocurrency Petro? This was the first cryptocurrency for crude oil. Venezuela capital is Caracas. Currency is Bolivar. Nicolas Maduro is the president. America has prohibited the purchase of Petro. India has imposed anti-dumping duty on buying of medicine called ofloxacin, very common antibiotic, from which country? We are protecting our domestic manufacturers by imposing duty on China. March 20 was observed by the United Nations to celebrate which language? There are six official languages of United Nations, and March 20 was for French. French. Now remember, the six languages are Arabic. For that, the day is 18 December. Then there is Russian. The day is 6th of June. Then we have Chinese, the day is 20th of April. And then we have English and Spanish. For both of these, the day is 23rd of April. Which state or union territory has launched a mobile app to search for singing and dancing talent? And the app is called Delhi State with Democracy. So it is done by the government of Delhi. Who has been named the next governor of the China Central Bank, the People's Bank of China, called PBOC? What is his name? His name is Yi Gang. And these are the four people most important. So foreign minister is Wang Yi, and he's also the state councillor now. Prime minister, again, it is Lee Keqiang. Earlier also it was him, now also it is him. Vice president is Wang Qishan, super important. President is Xi Jinping, and governor of the People's Bank of China is Yi Gang. President Ramnath Kovind recently released 10 rupee coin and 1000 rupee coin. These are commemorative coins. For which festival? This festival is celebrated once in 12 to 19 years, and it is the Lord Jagannath festival celebrated in Puri. So it is the Navakalabara festival. Which country has topped the medal tally for Pyeongchang Winter Para Olympic? Now pay attention on the word para. Para is America, and if word para was not here, then it was Norway. 39 medals Norway had won, and America has won in Paralympics maximum. They have won 36 medals. Out of that, 13 are gold medals. And he is the mascot called Asiatic Black Bear. Name is Bandabi. And for Winter Olympics, the mascot was Sohorang, the white tiger. Who has been re-elected as the vice president of Nepal? His name is Nanda Bahadur Pan. And president re-elected was Bindya Devi Bhandari, the first ever female president in the history of Nepal. Which state chief minister has launched the anti-graft portal to check corruption? It is the Uttar Pradesh government. Yogi Adityanath is the CM. Ajay Bisht is his original name. He's from Uttarakhand. And Ram Nayak is the governor. Which country has launched its own space agency called Hellenic Space Organization? Earlier, they were affiliated to European Space Agency. This country is Greece. Capital is Athens. Athens is the place where the first ever Olympic Games in 1896 were done. Which team won the Nidahas Trophy? They beat Bangladesh in the final. This was held in Colombo, Sri Lanka. It was won by India. Dinesh Karthik was awarded man of the match, and he hit the 6 runs of the last ball. Which state government has announced to set up a 100 crore apparel super hub at a place called Sarsila? It is the government of Telangana. Who has been given the additional charge as the governor of Odisha? It is Satyapal Malik, governor of Bihar, because SC Jamir is retired now. Bhel Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, again it's a Maharatan company. Bhel has commissioned the first unit of 110 megawatt of which hydro project in Jammu Kashmir? It is Kishan Ganga River project in Jammu Kashmir. Pakistan was objecting to it, but India made it nonetheless. Remember, Kishan Ganga is not Ganga. Ganga is a separate river. It takes origin from Uttarkashi district. Ganga is the longest river of India, 2525 km. And don't also confuse Kishan Ganga with Ven Ganga. Ven Ganga takes origin from Sioni district in Madhya Pradesh. And then it merges with Vardha River. And another river is Pan Ganga. Pan Ganga takes origin from Aurangabad in Maharashtra. And then it merges with Vardha once again. Which of the following chief ministers has released a handbook called Mahila Suraksha? He also launched an app for women's safety called Shakti. It is Jairam Thakur, CM of Himachal Pradesh. Who has become the second woman pilot in the Indian Air Force to fly solo? First was, of course, Avni Chaturvedi, everybody knows. Second is Bhavna Kant. Telangana Legislative Assembly has passed a bill. They have made Telugu compulsory till which language? Which class? It is the 10th class. Telugu is a language for Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. Telangana also made Urdu their second official language. Which of the following has partnered with Niti Aayog to work for the transformation of 115 aspirational districts? These aspirational districts are basically which are affected by terrorism or Naxalism. And remember that Kerala, Odisha and West Bengal are not participating in this scheme. Three states are not participating. KOWB, Kerala, Odisha and West Bengal. So the number of aspirational districts has reduced from 115 to 102. It is Piramal Foundation. Who has won the G.K. Reddy Memorial National Award for Journalism? One of his shows is very popular, which is called Devil's Advocate. His name is Karan Thapar. World's longest sandstone cave has been recently discovered. It is called Krempuri. It measures 24.5 kilometers. Where exactly has it been discovered? It has been discovered recently in Meghalaya. Conrad Sangma is the new CM of Meghalaya. India Post has recently released a special postal ticket, postal cover to pay tribute to which person? He is Stephen Hawking. And he wrote a book called A Brief History of Time. There is a movie also in his life called The Theory of Everything. He was from UK. Which of the following minesweeper ships were decommissioned by the Indian Navy because they have reached their functional life? INS Konkan, Cananore or Cuddalore? The answer is all of the above. Which city has become the first in North India to install automatic speed gun camera? Now if you break the speed limit or you kind of break the red light, then automatically it will get recorded in these speed gun camera and you will get a challan at your place. This city is first in North India. It is Chandigarh. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has recently approved continuation of Rashtriya Uchchatar Siksha Abhiyan, which basically wants to have 30% of gross enrollment ratio by 2020. So what is the deadline? Deadline is again 31st March 2020. IRCTC, Indian Railways Catering and Tourism Corporation, which recently signed a agreement with Ola. Now you can book Ola cab through IRCTC portal. It has launched the billing through point of sale handheld machines for the first time on a pilot basis in which train? Pilot basis means it is done at a small level or in one train. If it becomes successful, then it will be done throughout the India. It is done in the Karnataka Express. And who is the chairman of IRCTC? MP Mal. Which state celebrated 106th Foundation Day on March 22nd? It is Bihar. This also coincides with the first ever Satyagraha at Champaran. Who has flagged off a multi-utility vehicle which is called Naya Punya Ratham? It was done by Chandrababu Naidu, richest CM of India. Richest, Andhra Pradesh. Kuchipudi is a dance of Andhra Pradesh and Polavaram project they are building. Which state's animal husbandry department has signed a memorandum of understanding with Bharat Financial Inclusion to roll out an animal healthcare program called Pashu Dhan Sanjeevani 1962? Pashu Dhan Sanjeevani 1962, this program will be done by Madhya Pradesh. And remember, there is an app called Livestock Disease for Warning, LDF app, Livestock Disease for Warning, app launched by for 13 animal disease. And also, Rinderpest is a disease of cattle which has been eliminated from India. Which exchange has launched world's first future trading in brass? It is the multi-commodity exchange headed by Mrugang Paranjpe. Mrugang Paranjpe is the managing director and CEO of Multi-Commodity Exchange. Who has been sworn in as the president of Peru? Capital of Peru is Lima and his name is Mr. Martin Vizcarra. Union Cabinet has approved the continuation of National Health Mission with a budgetary support of 85,217 crore from April 2017 to what? This is also till 31st March 2020. Central government has approved the inclusion of Parivar and Talavar community for granting the ST status. So basically these two tribal communities are now given ST status, enabling them for reservation. This has been done by the government of Karnataka. Which airport has been declared the best airport in the world? These were the Skytrax World Airport Awards held in Stockholm, Sweden. It is Changi International Airport from Singapore. Who inaugurated the first Indian Sign Language Dictionary of 3000 words? It was done by the Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment, Thawar Chand Gehlot. Which state government has recently signed a Memorandum of Understanding with the British Council to strengthen their education and for cultural cooperation? This has been done by the Government of Odisha. Who has become the first woman opposition leader in Pakistan Senate? First woman leader. She is Shari Rahman and she is from Pakistan People's Party. India has given 18th railway locomotive engine to which country? This is a diesel engine. There were 18 that India was supposed to make. They have recently gifted them to Myanmar. Which city topped the Mercer's 20th annual quality of living survey? This city is Vienna, capital of OPEC. Headquarter of OPEC, I mean, capital of Austria. And remember, this award they have got for 9th year in a row. Which of the following institute in India have developed an instrument called fluorimeter that can detect if uranium is dissolved in water, even if it is in traces, very small quantities? It is Raja Raman Center for Advanced Technology, Indore. Indore is the cleanest city of India as per the Cleanliness Survey 2017. India recently test-fired which supersonic missile? This we got from Russia. It is called BrahMos. The important thing is that we first time used the indigenous seeker, made in India seeker. Seeker is used to influence the accuracy of a missile and to give it direction. We made it ourselves, this seeker. So this is very important. And BrahMos missile, we made it with the help of Russia. BrahMos, you divide it into two parts, Bra and Mos. Mos stands for Moscow. It is a river in Russia. And Bra stands for Brahmaputra. Which Indian shooter won the gold medal in the women's 10 meter air rifle event at ISSF Junior World Cup that was held in Sydney? Also remember that Manu Bhakar also won the gold medal in 10 meter air pistol in ISSF Junior World Cup, and this is Ella Vanil Valarivan. Which company has acquired Savan? This is a music app and they have merged it with their own app. So this is Reliance Industries. Their own app is called Jio Music and now Savan has been integrated into the same. So they will compete with Gaana app. Gaana app is by Times Internet, and they will also compete with Bharti Airtel's app called Wink. Cabinet Committee on Security, CCS, it has approved the construction of a new frontline airbase for the Indian Air Force at Gujarat. At which place? It is at Disa in a district called Banaskantha. Banaskantha district in Disa, Gujarat. Union Cabinet has approved the launch of Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Mission. It will subsume which of the following schemes? Subsume means these schemes will no longer exist. It will become a subset of Ayushman Bharat. It is Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana and Senior Citizen Health Insurance Scheme. So the answer is 1 and 2. And in this, we are targeting 10 crore families and 5 lakh insurance is given per year to a family. As per the World Prison Brief data, for every 1 lakh Indians, how many are in jail? There are 33, which is very less if you compare with America. In America, 666 Americans are in jail for every 1 lakh of their population. And if you talk about total number of people in jail, America has 2.1 million people in jail. India has only 0.4 million people in jail. Which indigenously built frigate of the Indian Navy will no longer be used by the Indian Navy because it has been decommissioned, because it has become very old. It was commissioned in 1985. It is INS Ganga. Which state government has imposed a permanent ban on hookah bar? It is Punjab government. They have completely banned hookah bar. Which airline flew direct flight to Israel city of Tel Aviv, but this time it used Saudi Arabia's airspace? For that it has got permission from Saudi Arabia and thereby decreasing the commute time by 2 hours. So this is Air India. Now government is doing privatization of Air India. Which of the following has been declared Kerala's official fruit? It is jackfruit. Union Cabinet has approved the extension of the term of the commission set up for the OBC subcategorization. Now, who is the chairman of the OBC subcategorization committee? She is Justice retired G. Rohini. External Publicity and Public Diplomacy Division under Ministry of External Affairs, they have launched something known as Videsh Aaya Pradesh Ke Dwar, where they launched it in Hyderabad. Union Cabinet has approved the amendment to the National Medical Commission Bill. Now, as per the amendment, the final MBBS exam, it will now be called what? It will be called NEXT, which means National Exit Test. It will no longer be called NEET. As per the Ministry of Drinking Water, which state has the highest number of tribal habitation fully covered by drinking water supply? Drinking water supply maximum is available in Madhya Pradesh for tribals, then Odisha, and then Jharkhand. These are the top three. Who won the 17th Asian Billboard Championship, Billiard Championship, that was held in old capital of Myanmar, Yangon? So he is multiple times world champion. His name is Pankaj Advani. Which team has won the 8th Hockey India Senior Men National Championship, A Division, that was held in Lucknow, capital of Uttar Pradesh? It was won by Hockey Punjab. They beat Petroleum Sports Promotion Board in the final. Where has an insect museum been opened in India recently? It is opened in Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu. Airport Authority of India, it has signed a memorandum of understanding with which state government for sustainable development of human settlement at villages in Kamrup district? So for that, Airport Authority of India will do the help of the Assam government. Kamrup district is in Assam. What is the name of the ship of LTTE terrorist organization that has been drowned or sunk by the Sri Lankan Navy? This ship was called V-Ling. Which state government has launched the scheme called Mission Sambhav, which means Mission Possible, to install 1 lakh toilet? It has been done by the government of Assam. In which position did India finish in the medal tally at the ISSF Junior World Cup that was held in Sydney in Australia? India finished at 2nd position behind China. India won 22 medals and China won 25 medals. Which state won the National Water Digest Award for water conservation efforts? This state is Chhattisgarh. Madhavpur Mela recently began at Madhavpur Gad in the state of, you have to tell which state it is. It is in Porbandar district in Gujarat. We had the Madhavpur Mela. Indian Navy's INS Tarkash, they recently carried out a gritting and training exercise with which country's navy? INS Tarkash, Indian naval ship Tarkash, they did the exercise with America. With America, we also do a Malabar exercise with Japan and America both. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's birth anniversary has been announced to be celebrated every year as the National Social Justice Day. Also, Ramji, his father's name has been added to his name. And when was it? It is on 14th of April, we celebrate the birthday of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, chairman of the drafting committee of the Constitution of India. And Swachh Bharat Divas is on April the 18th, Ujjwal Divas April 20, Farmers Welfare Day May the 2nd. And remember, Farmers Day is different from Farmers Welfare Day. Farmer Day is on 23rd of December, Farmer Welfare Day on May the 2nd. Farmer Day is the birthday of Chaudhary Charan Singh, ex-Prime Minister of India. And Kaushal Vikas Day, Skill Development Day on May the 5th. Which state has set up a seawater desalination plant of 100 million liter per day capacity? This has been done again in Gujarat, Jamnagar district. So the answer is Gujarat. Which of the following communication satellite has been launched by ISRO from GSLV F8 rocket from Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh? It is called GSLV 6A. India has overtaken which country to become the fourth largest automobile market in the world? India has overtaken Germany. Now number one is China, number two America, number three Japan, number four India. Which of the following countries has signed Brazzaville Declaration to protect the world's largest tropical peatland? Three countries: Democratic Republic of Congo, Republic of Congo, and Indonesia. So the answer is 1, 2, and 3. Which organization has received the Frederick Pincott Award for 2017? It is the South Asian Cinema Foundation. Who has been appointed as the principal scientific advisor to the government of India, and he will replace Mr. R. Chidambaram? His name is K. Vijay Raghavan. Who has been chosen as the flag bearer for the Commonwealth Games that will take place in Gold Coast, Australia? She is P.V. Sindhu, Olympic silver medalist. As per the data released by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which state has the highest number of beggars in India? West Bengal has the highest number of beggars in India, 80,000. The minimum beggars are in Lakshadweep, only 2 beggars. And among Union Territories, Delhi has the highest number of beggars, around 2,187. So West Bengal has 80,000 beggars. Total in India, we have 4,13,000 beggars. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the formulation of a new integrated scheme for school education. The new scheme, which is called integrated scheme, will subsume which of the following scheme, which means these schemes will no longer exist and become a part of this scheme. It is Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, and teacher education. The answer is all of the above. Which Formula One racer has won the first race of the current season 2018 Formula One Australian Grand Prix, won by Sebastian Vettel? He drives Ferrari car. Minister for Food Processing Industry Harsimrat Kaur Badal has inaugurated Rajasthan's first mega food park in which location? It has been done in Ajmer. Who has been appointed as the acting chairman of the National Green Tribunal? His name is Justice Jawad Rahim. Who has been appointed as the first CEO of Vodafone Idea merged company? His name is Balesh Sharma. What is the name of the world's largest cruise that is going to make its first journey from Barcelona. It is called Symphony of the Seas. Symphony of the Seas. As per our Economic Affairs Secretary Subhash Chandra Garg, India will become a $5 trillion economy by which year? Right now we are $2.5 trillion economy. We will become by 2025. Which of the following has become the first district in India to have 100% solar powered primary health center which cater to a population of 20 to 30,000? It is Surat, Diamond City in Gujarat. Asia's largest tulip garden has been opened for tourists at which place? It has been opened in Srinagar, capital of Jammu Kashmir. How much amount of loan is Asian Development Bank giving for the youth employability project to Himachal Pradesh? Total loan is $80 million. Which company conducted the integrated power development scheme to make Varanasi a wireless city? It is Power Grid India. So this was the long and very, very knowledgeable video for best 200 questions of March, rather 300 questions of March. I hope you liked the video, enjoyed the video. Please share the video so that I become motivated and bring almost every video in English also. Thank you so much for watching.